The Indiana Hoosiers are making their first bowl appearance since 1993. They've traveled over 8,000 fans to the Valley of the Sun as they take on Oklahoma State in the Inside Bowl. Oklahoma State is going to their fifth bowl in the last 6 years. They try to win their second bowl in a row. It should be a dandy with a lot of offense. Oklahoma State and Indiana. We welcome you inside Sun Devil Stadium in Tempe, Arizona, as NFL Network is proud to present the 2007 Inside Bowl as Indiana out of the Big Ten takes on the Oklahoma State Cowboys out of the Big 12. Led by head coach Mike Gundy, Oklahoma State, a prolific offense, Indiana all fired up for their first bowl appearance since 1993. Hello again, everyone. So glad you can join us for the Inside Bowl. I'm Bob Popple, along with Mike Mayock and Sterling Sharp. And guys, when you take a look at this football game, there's a lot of trust being put on the offenses of both of these teams. Mike, they have prolific scoring. Start with Oklahoma State.
Yeah, their quarterback, Zac Robinson, is really the catalyst. It's a team that averages 34 points a game, but he's surrounded by skill position talent as good as anywhere in the country. It starts at tailback. Dantrell Savage, 9 consecutive 100-yard games. He will make you miss in the hole. On the edge, well, they've got Adarius Bowman, 6'4", 220 pounds, 61 catches, even though he missed the last two games of the year. And then the guy who I think is the wild card, tight end Brandon Pettigrew, 35 catches, 6'6", 260 pounds. For Indiana, their quarterback, Kellen Lewis, may be the best zone read quarterback in the country. He averages 5 yards a carry. He's thrown 26 touchdown passes. And the key is you can't pay too much attention to him because of the wide receiver, James Hardy. 6'7", reminds me a little bit of Plaxico Burress when he came out of Michigan State. 74 catches, 16 of them for touchdowns. Are you kidding me? Probably the best red zone guy in the country.
By far. And when you look at these two football teams, the bad is the defense. And when you look at these defenses, Oklahoma State, it's all about their team. Why? Because they're a zone blitz scheme kind of defense. You're not going to get them in single coverage if they can help it. But I think Austin Thomas of Indiana is going to have to wear the hat in this game. The strong safety is going to be caught in space a lot with the skill guys that Mike just mentioned from Oklahoma State. Bob, if he doesn't make the tackle, it could be a big game. A
lot of space, baby.
Yes, sir.
Pre-game, we had fireworks. We're expecting fireworks when the game starts. It's an emotionally charged contest for Indiana. Back in June, their head coach Terry Hettner passed away after a battle with brain cancer. It's going to be a very emotional night for Indiana. We'll have more on that in the kickoff after this timeout on NFL Network. From just across the Tempe Town Lake, we welcome you to Sun Devil Stadium for the 2007 Inside Bowl as Indiana squares off against Oklahoma State. The first bowl appearance for Indiana since 1993. They've dealt with the passing of their head coach, Terry Kepner, back in June. A lot of emotion for the Hoosiers of Indiana. For more on that, we send it down to Kim Jones.
Thank you, Bob. Well, Coach Hep is never far from the hearts and minds of anyone on this Indiana sideline, and he's memorialized on their helmet. You'll see this decal on every helmet tonight, with the number 13 and the words, "Don't quit." It was Terry Hepner's dream that these Hoosiers would play 13 games. They're doing so tonight, of course. And "Don't Quit" was his favorite poem. The players tell me he didn't read it to us. He recited it because he knew it by heart. This is an emotionally charged sideline tonight. One Hoosiers coach telling me, this isn't a bowl game for us. It's a Super Bowl. So how does Oklahoma State battle that? Coach Mike Gundy has told his players, guys, we don't just have to play well. We have to match Indiana's intensity. Bob?
We'll see how they come out early in this football game. Both teams obviously prolific offensively. As you get a look at head coach Mike Gundy in his third year at Oklahoma State. Oklahoma State won the toss. They're in the orange. They have elected to defer until the second half, as Dan Bailey, a freshman from Oklahoma, will kick the football off for Oklahoma State. Coach Gundy in his third year, 17-19, as the head coach at Oklahoma State. He played for the Cowboys.
He had some pretty good help, though, with tailback. Thurman Thomas, one of those guys, Sterling, you know what I mean?
Barry Sanders.
Sanders,
you know what? Yeah, guys are okay. I mean, where are those guys anyway nowadays? I mean, when you you have that kind of talent in the backfield, it makes any quarterback look good.
And Bill Lynch, the head coach of Indiana, signed a contract extension in November through 2012. So we're getting set for the start of the inside bowl as Oklahoma State will kick it off. Dan Bailey will boot it. Marcus Thigpen back deep for Indiana. Short kick by Bailey. And it's fielded by James Bailey of Indiana. Bailey up to the 23-yard line, and he gets knocked down there on the play. Tackle made by Bryant Ward. As we take a look at the offense for the Indiana Hoosiers, and they're led by quarterback Kellen Lewis, second team all Big Ten. James Hardy, the outstanding wide receiver, 16 touchdown catches this season. When you take a look at their offensive line, pretty good up front. Roger Stafford and James Sandberg are the key components on that offensive line. Sandberg, a Big Ten honorable mention, All-American. And Charlie Emerson from Westport, Connecticut. So first and 10 for the Hoosiers, and Kellen Lewis. Mike, for the fans that have not seen Indiana, what should they expect from them early offensively?
A lot of zone read. He's quick as a hiccup. Watch the running back cross in front. Either give it or take it.
That's Thigpen. Trying to bounce outside and cannot, as he got shut down in a hurry by Andre Sexton, who got the start at linebackers. We take a look at the Cowboys defensively. Marquis Fountain is one of the key components on the front line, along with Nathan Peterson, second team all Big 12. Peterson, six tackles and 14 tackles for a loss on the season. Donovan Woods, a senior, 73 tackles on the year. Terrence Anderson makes his first start of the season at corner, and the safeties have combined for 127 tackles. Second and 13 for Indiana.
Oklahoma State's already in the rod front. They're going to heat it up early.
Lewis to throw his first attempt. Lewis zips it. He's got Hardy to the 34-yard line. And it's a good catch. And a first down, gain of 14 on the play.
That is a tough matchup. Why? Because they're trying to bump James Hardy at the line to slow him down. Kellen Lewis does an outstanding job. Look at the location of the football away from the defender. Hardy goes down, makes the grab, first down, Indiana.
And what's interesting about Lewis is typically when he steps up into the pocket, he's going to run. That time he threw the ball. He kept his eyes down the field. Big first down.
It looked like Oklahoma State had a spy on him as well.
So on a first and 10 for Lewis, he works out of the gun with Thigpen to his left. Hardy lined up to the bottom of your screen. Lewis looks elsewhere, completes it up to the 40-yard line. And he's able to find his tight end, Nick Sexton. A fifth-year senior out of Bloomington, his third catch of the season.
Now, they don't throw to the tight end.
Did you say third catch of the season?
Third catch of the season.
And he's the leading receiver amongst their tight ends. I mean, his backup, Troy Wagner, has two. So they got five between them now.
Wow. I mean, when you know what? It's a bowl game, and you really don't know what to expect. So when you throw to a guy that came into this game with two catches, you're really catching a defense on guard.
Gain of seven on the play. Hardy lined up to the top of your screen, split right. Thigpen remains the tailback on a second and three. Pressure on Lewis. Nethon with the pressure, but there's the legs of Lewis. He's got a first down and more, dragged down at the 46-yard line of Oklahoma State.
Really interesting what's going on. It's all odd man front, which Oklahoma State is not an odd front team. They're a four-man front. They're going three-man rush, and they're bringing five. Man-free coverage. They turn free. Number 19, Nathan. So what happens, Sterling? You get an athlete who's a better athlete at the quarterback position. He beats Nathan.
And then you got man-to-man coverage. So everybody else is chasing a wide receiver, and there's just yards for the taking, and Kellen Lewis is picking up those free yards.
Lewis averaged 4.8 yards a carry, eight rushing touchdowns during the regular season. First and 10 for Indiana. Opening possession of the ball game. Thigpen hit by Nathan and dropped after a gain of a couple. Jeremy Nathan, a senior out of Beggs, Oklahoma. He was the defensive MVP of the Independence Bowl last year for Oklahoma State.
I know one thing so far, Sterling, and they've run the ball twice now as far as the give, both for negative yards or close to negative yards. Where they're getting it is in the pass game and with the creativity already of Kellen Lewis.
And Oklahoma State's defense, understandably so, give up about 455 yards a game. So you have the opportunity to run it because they give up 153 yards, but throw it as well, almost 300 yards passing they give up.
Brian Payton comes in at tailback as Lewis takes the snap, rolls, and completes it on the near sideline short of the sticks. As he gets it off to Ray Fisher. He's a sophomore from Cleveland, Ohio. That's his 50th catch of the season.
Again, when you don't have a great offensive line, what you do is you change the launch point.
You got to change it.
And you get a mobile quarterback that can get out on the edge. That's a way to protect a weak offensive line, and they've had pass protection issues all year long.
Well, they should have an easy day. Why? Because Oklahoma State didn't get to the quarterback a whole lot anyway, only 21 and a half sacks all season. So moving that launch point puts him in a run pass option. More options you can get from the quarterback, the better.
Third and two now for Indiana. They hit their third downs at 42%. Lewis, quick release and completes it to Payton out of the backfield, and he's got a first down at the 31-yard line. Dangerous pass, but he got it to Payton, who makes his 11th catch of the season.
Dangerous because Jacob Lacey, the corner, almost picked it off. As a matter of fact, he used the wrong arm. Watch what happens. Here comes the running back on a little pick play. Now, if that corner uses the left arm, the inside arm, instead of the right arm, he knocks that ball down.
I don't know, but the location and the speed that Lewis had on that, you still think he got it, knock it down?
I'm telling you, from a technique perspective, from a former defensive back, if you reach with the correct arm, you get an extra 6 inches.
Teach me something.
First and 10 at the 31 of Oklahoma State. Indiana with the ball, thick pen. They run the reverse.
They got it.
To the near side, do they get the blocking?
Nope.
And they do not, as Fisher gets knocked out of bounds. His first carry of the season. And he gets a couple on the play.
And yeah, that's the guy they like on reverses and bubble screens. He's small, Fisher, 5'9", 175. Real quick, look at Ugo Chinasa, number 91. Pretty good for a big guy. Forces him into the sideline. He gets help from Donovan Woods, the outside linebacker. That's team football. Discipline, responsibility on the backside.
And that's what Oklahoma State has to. They can't allow themselves to be singled out with the skill that Indiana brings, because in space, you're not going to bring these guys down one-on-one.
Ninth play of the drive coming up. Second and 8 for Indiana. Big Ben gets a block and gets cut down at the 25-yard line. Four short of the first down, as Donovan Woods came in to make the hit along with Jacob Lacey.
I'm liking what I'm seeing from Indiana. I mean, they're mixing it up, quarterback keeping it on and running their zone read.
Yep.
Their bread and butter play, and they're just getting the feel for how Oklahoma State's defense is going to play.
If they can run the football just a little bit Big Ben to keep it honest, then they got everything they want, because you're going to see the ride, the glide, and the decide.
Uh-huh.
And the decide is when the quarterback keeps it and goes.
Indiana hit on a third and short. This is a third and 4 now, as the 10th play of the drive is coming up.
Running back is offset in the position where he's going to get out in the route.
Play clock at 1 as Lewis takes the snap. Feels pressure, and he's trying to get away from pressure. Chased out and flips it to the sideline, incomplete. Good pressure on the play again by Chinasa.
Now, that's a young quarterback, Sterling.
Yes, it is.
Who had his running back, Big Ben, for a first down. And I could tell from the alignment of the running back, he cheated out wide to get out in the route.
Had no blocking responsibilities. Get him on the wide. Get the ball in his hands one-on-one. Get him in space.
In space is the word, right?
Yep.
That's a first down. One-on-one in space. And that's a young quarterback.
Austin Starr, who's an academic All-American in biology, a junior from Logansport, Indiana, will try a 43-yard field goal from the left hash. Snap is good. He's got the distance, and it's good from 43 yards out. Austin Starr gets Bill Lynch and Indiana on the board on the opening drive of the ball game. Hoosiers lead it by 3. Back in Tempe, Arizona for the inside ball. Indiana goes 11 plays, 52 yards, and Austin Starr with a 43-yard field goal to get the Hoosiers on the board. Now the opening possession of the ball game, and move the football around pretty nice and give the Indiana fans something to cheer about.
Yeah, I really thought the key there was Kellen Lewis. We've talked about it all week, his improvisational skills. One time a 14-yard scramble, and Sterling the other time scrambled to throw the football.
Sure, and when you look at what Oklahoma State did on defense, they have to be happy. They didn't get beat up by Hardy early on, which is what IU wanted to do coming into this football game. I think they got to pay attention to the middle, though, Mike. That zone read play is designed to hit up inside. That's where Oklahoma State defensively has been their weakest. I expect to see a lot more zone read from IU.
Back deep to the left of your screen is Dantrell Savage and Aldarius Thompson, a sophomore from Mesquite, Texas, awaiting the kickoff from Austin Starr. Thompson will field it at his own 14. And then he gets shouldered down at the 33-yard line. Big hit on the play by Matt Mayberry. Let's take a look at the starting offense for Oklahoma State, led by quarterback Zac Robinson, a sophomore. Who had 430 yards passing. There's a Darius Bowman. He is outstanding. 61 catches and 7 touchdowns. Dez Bryant, a speed merchant. Offensive line led by David Koenig. He's a senior from Florida. 36 consecutive starts.
A little different defensively. 4-3, a lot of zone out of Indiana.
And you know where they're going to line up every single time because that's just who they are. Very good note.
Robinson on the pitch to Savage. Savage fights up to the 39-yard line as he gets dragged down from behind by Justin Carrington as we take a look at the Indiana Hoosiers defensively. So take a look at the defensive front with Jamie Curlew. They're anchored by Greg Middleton. Middleton with 16 sacks on the season, 17 tackles for a loss, first team all Big Ten. Will Peter Patterson, 99 tackles at the linebacker position this year. And then Leslie Majors and Tracy Ford, the outstanding corners, as on a first and 10, they run the football again. This time it's Robinson, and he takes it out across midfield.
As advertised, Mike, is that what you're going to say? As advertised? I mean,
they want to run option. And any former defensive player knows how difficult option is to defend when you have a balanced run game and pass game. Zac Robinson had 3 100-yard rushing days this year.
Uh-huh.
He's faster than people think. He ran 4.5 40 and was considered as a wide receiver coming out of high school.
Robinson checking with the sideline. He set the Oklahoma State record for 3,299 yards, the most total yards in a single season. A little strip screen to Bowman, and he's able to work his way up to the 45-yard line. Gets tackled from behind by Leslie Majors, a senior from South Holland, Illinois.
When you look at Oklahoma State offensively, what they want to do is spread you out to run the football. But they also are looking for the matchups. If they can find those one-on-ones and throw little screens like that to get their playmakers in space, you're going to hear space a lot tonight from us. That's what they really want to do.
Trying to get it to Savage. Can't reverse his field. Looking for a block. Good pursuit by Tracy Porter, and he drags him down, but a flag comes in on the play.
Got to be a 15-yard face mask. Has to be.
Probably is, but I like Tracy Porter on the backside discipline, not letting the quarterback outside of him. Athletic play by the corner. I think the second guy in the tackle might have gotten a hand on the face mask.
But you got to like the fact that Porter stayed home.
I did. It showed me some discipline. He's one of the most, in my opinion, I've watched all the senior corners on tape, and he's one of the most talented there are.
Personal foul, face mask on the defense. Penalties enforced from the previous spot, 15 yards, first down.
15. And that's a killer. That's almost like a turnover. Could have had a big defensive play, and it is Tracy Porter. Looks like they grabbed each other's face mask to me.
Yeah, but the guy with the ball never gets caught.
Well, I mean, and I got a little problem with that, Sterling. Everything's skewed against the defense.
You defensive guys always have problems with the rules.
Put a skirt on the quarterback. Don't touch anybody. Let the wide receivers get loose after 5 yards. I mean, that's what it's all about.
Yesterday during the Jaguars game, they actually called an offensive face mask.
He's fired.
Nice fake.
Great fake. As they work it inside the 20-yard line, that's Brandon Pettigrew, the first-team All-Big 12 tight end.
Love the play action here. It's a little slow read by the tight end, and he's going to sneak out into the flat. When you can run the football, you can set up right here. Slow block, get away. Now he's got point receivers on three levels. He takes the lowest level. You make somebody miss right there. Sterling, that's 6'6", 260 right there,
brother.
I was
just getting ready to say that. 6'6", 260 with a spin move. That's not one of those things you teach, folks. You get out of bed with that.
Savage, the tailback. There was Porter who missed the tackle.
He didn't want to tackle him. That's Pettigrew.
Bowman in motion. Savage on the handoff. Gets a crease to the 5, and he gets cut down at the 3-yard line. Touchdown saving tackle made by Nick Polk for safety.
As advertised means, this is exactly what Oklahoma State told us they wanted to do. This is exactly what Oklahoma State came in this game to do. This is exactly what they're doing, Mike. Great read, stretch play right out the gate. Got everybody passing
on. Tight end on the safety, your guy, Austin Thomas.
Adaris Bowman with a great block as well. Spring the running back.
Savage again right up the middle, fighting for the goal line, and a touchdown.
3 yards for the touchdown.
Dantrell Savage, who had 112 yards rushing. last year's Independence Bowl win. Gets a touchdown here in the inside ball, and Oklahoma State takes the lead.
And I'm going to tell you exactly what this game's going to be all about. Okay. We talked about explosion in offense. It's about scoring touchdowns, not field goals. That's what this game's going to be about.
That was an aggressive drive.
Zac Robinson ran it to perfection. Dan Bailey for the extra point. 13 of 13 on the season, and he rips that right through. So after an Indiana field goal on the opening possession of the ball game, it's Oklahoma State coming right back as Dantrell Savage gets his ninth touchdown of the season. Cowboys in front, 7-3 in the first. Oklahoma State goes 67 yards in six plays. Savage with the touchdown run. Three of the six plays were 12 yards or longer. As they picked up yards in chunks, and they take the lead 7-3 as Dan Bailey will kick off for the Cowboys. Marcus Thigpen and James Bailey await the kick for Indiana. Good high kick. And Bailey in his own end zone, and he'll take the knee there, and Indiana will start at their own 20-yard line on their second possession of the ball game. Obviously an emotional time for Indiana with the passing of Coach Hepner this past summer. Bill Lynch has done a tremendous job. The 13th game, so important for this team. We'll have more on that throughout the course of the afternoon. Their first bowl appearance since 1993. And by the way, I did that game. It was the Independence Bowl in 1993. Bill Lynch was on that staff. Interestingly enough, they played Virginia Tech. From that day, both programs went diametrically opposite directions.
Did you say diametrically?
I'm just trying to see if you're still awake, Stan.
Diametrically.
Lewis on the play fake, and he just throws it away in space. For more on the Coach Hepner story, let's send it down to Kim Jones.
Thank you, Bob. I am with the most popular person in this stadium, Jane Hepner. Everyone here, including the Oklahoma State fans, gave you a standing ovation. What's this moment like for you?
You know what? That is simply a tribute to my husband and who he was and what he stood for and the legacy that he has left us. How awesome is that?
Well, and he's left quite a legacy. Bill Lynch and the whole program continue to embrace his vision. How important is that to you?
It is. It's so important because Terry was about the right stuff. He was about not quitting. He was about absolutely facing adversity without blinking and keeping on with your goals and your dreams, and what we see today is a result of that.
He was also about a family atmosphere, and I know every one of these Hoosiers players wanted a hug from you before
the
game.
I know. I'm sorry, but that's just kind of a thing we do, so, yeah.
I have to ask you about James Hardy. Your husband had such a special relationship, like a second father to James. For him to have the kind of junior season he had, it was almost like a personal tribute to your husband, wasn't it?
Yes, and James would say that. I think he would agree, and it's been wonderful for me to see him play the way that he has, because I do think it's absolutely all for Terry.
Jane, we thank you. We congratulate you.
Thank you. Thanks, Kim.
Back to you, Bob.
Well, we'll see if James Hardy can make a big play here on a 3rd and 10 for Indiana from their own 20-yard line. Hardy to the top of your screen, split right. Lewis with time looking for Hardy, who can't pull it out of the air. A little high. Ricky Price on the coverage.
Now, Sterling, that time they set up like they were going to come, and they went coverage. Uh-huh. They went with a three-man rush. They dropped eight. Played a three-deep zone behind.
And it looked like they played all eight, dropped all eight inside where they knew James Hardy was going to be. Beautiful step in the pocket, beautiful throw, and I think Hardy would tell you every day and twice on the day, he should make that catch.
And I give Lewis credit. He looked off the safety because they had
a good job of moving.
Single high safety. Yep. He manipulated the safety, came back the other way into the seam.
Yep.
Michael Hines to punt. Dez Bryant to receive it. Bryant from his own 40-yard line. Slips through a couple tackles and takes it up to the 47-yard line. And that's where Oklahoma State will start 1st and 10. The Cowboys with a 7-3 lead here at the Inside Bowl on NFL Network. Welcome back to Sun Devil Stadium in Tempe, Arizona. It's the Inside Bowl. Oklahoma State with a 7-3 lead over Indiana. So glad you can join us. Bob Papa, Sterling Sharp, Mike Mayock, and Kim Jones. Oklahoma State with the football. They'll work out of an eye. They went six plays, 67 yards on their first possession. Now they'll work out of an eye with Savage, the tailback. Zach Carter, the fullback. Robinson to throw for Bowman. Good coverage
nice
by
job.
Tracy Porter, the cornerback.
Feel and fall, Mike. Feel and fall. And that's beautiful. That's beautiful technique by, and I'm a receiver. And I know that is just beautiful technique because he played the man, and as soon as he thought the ball was coming, he looked back and then just put his body in the place for where the wide receiver thought the ball was going to be. Watch him feel and fall. Look at that. That is just beautiful technique. And you know what? That's two great athletes going at it. Defense wins this one.
Look and lean is the way I learned it. Look
feel
back
and
late. Lean into them.
Well, they changed it a few years ago. Feel and fall.
Robinson out of play fake. Gets it out to Dez Bryant, and Bryant fights for first down yardage before he's knocked out of bounds. Bryant, a true freshman from Lufkin, Texas, great All-American high school football player.
And Bill, and I mean, he's hard to bring down one-on-one. I mean, and now what you're talking to see, we're talking about is space. You get him, you get Dez in space again, and all of a sudden he breaks a tackle with that nice frame he has for a body. First down, Oklahoma State. I mean, they're doing a very good job of attacking Indiana's defense.
Austin Thomas was the one who missed the tackle for Indiana. Robinson on the fake, dragged down from behind and gets nothing. As Matt Mayberry, a sophomore from Darien, Illinois, made the tackle. A physical education teaching major, 20 years of age.
Now, Mayberry's a former high school running back. Look for 43 to flash. Right there, he beats the block, makes the tackle. Not only did he beat the block there, Sterling, but he had the presence. And what the coaches talked about with him is not as instinctive yet as you'd like, because
right.
He wasn't a defensive player in high school. But that's a great job right there by the former running back.
Second and 13 for Zac Robinson and the Cowboys of Oklahoma State. Robinson gets some pressure up front, but completes it along the sideline at the 25-yard line. That's the tight end Brandon Pettigrew again.
I'm starting to like the Zac Robinson guy playing quarterback. I mean, he had no way to step up and throw the football. He threw a beautiful ball out to his outstanding tight end, Brandon Pettigrew. I mean, watch him just hang in the pocket. Hang. Now, the pocket is collapsing. And look how he throws it. And he throws an absolute strike. And Pettigrew with these hands. I mean, for a guy that big, the way he plays, outstanding football player.
Greg Brown got pressure up the middle, but Robinson still completes the pass. First and 10, Robinson for Savage. Trying to find his way outside, gets off the tackle, and then wrestled down at the 20-yard line. Tracy Porter on the tackle.
You know what the key there was? Adarius Bowman, the wide receiver on option, comes down, and watch Adarius Bowman on the walk-away backer right here. That's the key block right there.
I love
comes
to
down.
Block.
Look at him, a wide receiver. You don't have to kill anybody, and then he cuts him.
And you know what?
How good a job is that, Sterling, for a wide
out? And talking to him this week, he talked about having the ability and loving the block.
Now, Tracy Porter, first team All Big Ten defensive back and the second leading interceptor in IU history, is down and hurt right now.
Well, I hope he's okay. He's one of the most special corners in the country and a guy they really need today.
We're going to take a timeout. We'll check on Tracy Porter here in the first. Oklahoma State with a 7-3 lead. Senior Tracy Porter of Indiana remains down from Port Allen, Louisiana. First team All Big Ten player this year. 16 career interceptions, the most in Indiana history. On a running play to Savage, he collided with his own teammate, Greg Brown.
From the right side, Brown. Look at the helmet-to-helmet contact on Porter. Keep in mind, Brown is a 300-pound, three-technique nose tackle. Bang, helmet-to-helmet on 186-pound Tracy Porter. That's 114-pound differential
on a guy you didn't expect to be there,
right.
Too. And you know, having had a neck injury and having been to where you can move but you don't have the control over your body that you want, it looked like from that, just watching when we were in break, watching Tracy move, looked like he got burned a little bit. And what that means is you can move, but you have no control over your movement. You have no control over your body. You can move your arm, but you can't do exactly what the training staff is telling you. They were telling him asking him to move his right leg, and what he did was is he actually came from it being flat to bringing it up to being bent a little bit. So he got stung pretty good right there. I mean, I'm not a doctor, and I don't know what his injury could be, but having bumped my spine several times, I'm familiar with what he's feeling right now.
When you get these collisions between teammates, defensive players flying in, what's going through Greg Brown's mind right now?
Well, the thing is both guys are rallying to make a play, Mike, and you know, you really try not to take it out on your teammate, but both guys are rallying to make a play. And you hope it doesn't take away Greg's aggressiveness for the rest of the game.
Yeah, Greg Brown knows he was hustling to the ball, just like Tracy Porter was. You can't blame yourself. You hate that your brother is hurt, and you know you're really happy right now he's walking off the field. There could be a concussion there. You know, everybody that's ever played the game, Sterling, has had stingers before.
Yes.
And my heart goes out to the kid.
Tracy Porter has helped off. Log on to iwantnflnetwork.com to find out how to get the only television network dedicated to the NFL 24/7, 365. iwantnflnetwork.com. NFL Network, your home for football 24/7. Christopher Phillips, a redshirt junior, has come in to replace Tracy Porter.
I'd go right at him right now.
Bowman in motion. Savage trying to bounce it outside, finds a crease. Savage to the 10 and knocked down from behind.
Wow,
how Patterson on the tackle.
How much do I like Brandon Pettigrew, this tight end? You and I are looking at each other.
Yeah, we're looking at the same thing.
Right here, okay, base block, and then watch him get out to the outside and get a second one. There's the base. Now, who am I going to get? Turns to his outside. You don't have to kill anybody, Sterling. You got to get in the way, give your running back an opportunity to cut it up inside. Boy, is he athletic and a little instinct for the game.
Yes, he is.
First and goal at the 10 for Oklahoma State. Savage on the inside handoff, and it's shut down after a gain of only one.
Late hit there.
Dez Bryant. Yep, Dez Bryant got caught. He got caught.
True freshman, getting a little excited.
You know what, I'm not getting any catches, so I want to feel a part of this bowl game. It's my first one, I want to be involved.
There you go. Right at the very end, not only did he hit him late, he clipped him. I mean, that's as bad as it gets right there. Mike Gundy is not going to be happy with that play by true freshman Dez Bryant.
And that was Christopher Phillips, who's in for Tracy Porter. So they went it.
That's inexcusable.
They went at Phillips, but the wrong way.
Yeah, the wrong way. Yeah, definitely the wrong way. And it's one of those things in a system where you throw it around, you spread people out, you get one-on-ones. You know, the wide receivers have had two balls thrown in their direction, so you just want to feel a part of the game. I mean, it's a silly play. It's a bad penalty, but that's what caused it.
Now it's second and goal from the 24. Oklahoma State scored a touchdown on their first possession. It was Savage with a three-yard run. Robinson with the pump fake looks over the middle for Bryant, who makes a sliding catch for a touchdown.
Beautiful catch right there.
And a poor job by Nick Polk, the free safety. He never got his head around. Remember, Sterling, we talked about the corner. Watch what happens here. Polk's got an opportunity to make a play. There's the pump fake. Now Polk's got to run with him underneath. Turn your head. Never turned his head.
Never
identified the football.
These wide receivers are technically the best wide receivers that I've had a chance to watch in college football this season. I mean, you saw how his elbows got together, Bob, cradled that football.
Fifth touchdown catch for Bryant. Go right to the guy who committed the dump play, the play before with the penalty.
Okay, out of the doghouse. I give up.
Dan Bailey hits the extra point. Dez Bryant, a true freshman from Lufkin, Texas, with his fifth touchdown catch of the season. Oklahoma State with a 14-3 lead here in the first. Reception caps an 8-play, 53-yard drive for Oklahoma State. They've run 14 offensive plays. They have 14 points.
Wow.
Bryant was the one who committed the personal foul penalty that set up the second goal at the 24, and he made Indiana pay for it.
I'm wondering when Indiana's offense is going to respond. And I think right now, Mike, what we should start to look for is a lot more Lewis and a lot more Hardy and a lot less everybody else.
If you remember the first drive, mm-hmm. It was Kellen Lewis
right
in the scramble game.
Right.
When I talked to the defensive coaches at Oklahoma State, they were like, we hope he's in the pocket throwing on time because he's most dangerous outside the pocket.
Right.
And maybe they can get a special teams play to give him a spark here. Bailey, one of the two men back deep, has returned one for a touchdown this season, 91 yards. Yep. He's back with Big Ben. Gets some field position.
He went 91 against Northwestern, and he's an explosive kid.
Chip Bailey will kick it off for the Cowboys of Oklahoma State, who have just marched downfield effortlessly here in this first quarter of play. Indiana had the first offensive possession of the ball game. They had to settle for three field goals, as Mike, you mentioned earlier, are not going to win this game. Good kick by Bailey. And big pass will stay in the end zone. James Bailey said, hold it right there. So for the second consecutive possession, Indiana will start at their own 20 as we check in with Kim on the sideline.
Bob, Tracy Porter has been diagnosed with a concussion. The training staff tells me his return is questionable. They also tell me he's communicating as usual, which they see, of course, as a very good sign.
Big loss for Indiana if Porter's not able to play. He's their playmaker on defense, especially in that back four. Fisher goes in motion for quarterback Kellen Lewis of Indiana. Payton the tailback. Now Fisher comes back in motion. Payton on the handoff, and it gets knifed down quickly by Andre Sexton, the sophomore linebacker out of Houston, Texas, a sports management major.
And I don't think Indiana has to panic here. I just think they, you know, continue to run your offense. You're a running football team to set up the throw. You do a good job throwing it when you want to throw it. So I don't think they need to panic and abandon the game plan that they worked on the last month coming into this game. But they do need to stay on the field for a little while.
They got to give their defense a rest.
Yes.
And they've got to establish a couple things. Like, I thought they had it going a little bit on that first drive.
Second and seven. Payton remains the running back in this formation. Lewis to throw, looking for a Hardy down the left sideline. He can't bring it in.
Safety did a nice job coming over the top. That was Quentin Moore. It was one-on-one in that situation. I like Hardy's chance here. However, with Moore coming over top, Sterling, here it is, down the bottom of the screen. One-on-one ISO situation. That's the pre-read. However, that's a good job by the big guy getting on top of him.
Oh, right.
Look at Quentin Moore getting involved.
And you know what? I thought that ball went through Hardy's hands, and it did.
It did.
Right through his arm.
It did.
So there's two throws now that he should have caught, got his hands on, that end up drops, incomplete passes. So he's going to have to play as big as a 6'7" frame will allow him to, and he's got to make those catches.
Indiana 1-for-3 on their third down so far. This a third and seven. Lewis with some time. Lewis just lobs it out of bounds in the direction of Hardy.
He had his fullback, Josiah Sears, right over the middle for about a 9-yard gain, which was an easy throw. But, you know, he's trying to buy some time, and he got outside. And when you got stopped short right at the first down sticks and everybody's crowding him, I mean, he has his fullback that's going to come into the middle of your picture right there. And, I mean, right now, if he just looks inside, he's got his fullback because there's no one there. Stops on the outside. Good job by the Oklahoma State defense getting off the field on third down.
Second straight three and out. Hines just got the punt away. Pretty good one as Bryant feels it on the run. And he gets run out of bounds at the 47-yard line. After about a 7-yard return, after a 37-yard punt. NFL Network has every NFL playoff game re-aired in an enhanced 90-minute show. NFL Replay every week in January, only on NFL Network.
37-yard
playoff action begins this weekend. Pittsburgh and Jacksonville.
I don't think Jacksonville can go in Pittsburgh and beat them twice.
How about Washington, where they're playing right now? They're in Seattle on Saturday afternoon.
And I think Washington can win that, too.
The Giants in Tampa on Sunday, and San Diego and Tennessee in the late game on Sunday. Flag on the play as Robinson pitches it out to his tailback, Kendall Hunter, a freshman from Tyler, Texas. He gets a couple.
This is really difficult for the Indiana defense. The snap differential, offensive plays for Oklahoma State versus offensive plays for Indiana, are quite different right now. They're on the field too much, and I'm telling you, Sterling, 21-3 isn't going to look real good.
No, it's not going to feel real good either. And I mean, that's when you're going to need your guys.
Offside number 57, lined up the neutral zone. Wow. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Jamie Curlew, the left end, was in the neutral zone. Well, Oklahoma State, 14 offensive plays, 14 points. You had the good drive by Indiana. They settled for the field goal, and they've gone three and out on two consecutive possessions.
Hustling up the line, tight bunch set to the top.
First and five. Hunter again. Hunter gets a block, and he's got the first down. Marcus Ford's progress at the 44-yard line.
See, they get that tight bunch, and if they don't throw, they like the toss sweep because they get more people over there, and they block your contain guy. In that case, they got Justin Carrington, the outside linebacker, hooked, and it's an easy 5 yards and a first down.
Yes, it is. I mean, they do a good job of spreading the field, and that's what they want to do. They want to get wide on you. They want to get their guys on the corners on you, and if they can, I mean, it makes for a long day for a defense chasing sideline to sideline.
First and 10 for Oklahoma State. Robinson has a screen set up for Hunter. Hunter inside the 30 gets a block and knocked out of bounds inside the 20-yard line.
Double
Adam
screen.
McClurg on the tackle.
Double screen. David Koenig, their left guard, does a great job out front. This is why he's second team all Big 12. Watch 61. There's the pump fake to the right. They come back to the left. Now watch Koenig cut his guy. He sets him up. Bang. You're gone. Nice cut by the tailback. Classic job with the double screen.
16 offensive plays. 9 first downs already for Oklahoma State. We're still in the first. They lead it 14-3, looking for more. 1-on-1. Bryant working on Phillips, who's in for Porter. Fights off the tackle, and then Robinson's Phillips gets some help from Austin line. Thomas.
I think Dez is a little excited because I talking to him and spending time with him this week, he's one of those kids that just can't wait to make a play. And I just think right now, if he hits it back inside, he scores. If he just hits it right back inside, he scores. But, you know, got to show off some moves. Show off some moves, though. But he's going to be an outstanding football player.
Second and 3. Hunter, the freshman, fights his way to about the 9-yard line. He's about a half yard short of the first down.
You talk about balance in an offensive attack, Sterling. This offense of Oklahoma State, they average 246 rush yards per game,
right?
238 pass yards a game,
right?
And they're coming downhill right now, and you don't know what to stop.
First third down, and Robinson will keep it, and they move the pile forward, and he's got the first down.
I know everybody listening to us talk about how dominant Oklahoma State's looking on offense, defense doing a great job. How in the world is this football team 6-6 playing in the inside bowl? No disrespect to the inside bowl people, but how is this football team 6-6?
I got one word for you. Defense. You know, you can't tell me that you're a 12-1 or an 11-1 kind of team and you give up almost 500 yards a game on defense.
Right.
Robinson keeps it. Robinson to the goal line. Touchdown, Zac Robinson.
You talk about patience running the football from a quarterback. Are you kidding me? I mean, all he did was he came out the right side and he just stayed patient, but he was gaining yardage, zone read, gonna keep it.
Zone read, correct.
Gonna keep it, now I'm on the outside. Now look, he's just gaining yardage, and then steps up inside.
How about Bowman and Bryant with the blocks, the receivers?
Those I know wide receivers, Bob, love blocking.
I love the fact that they block the way they do.
And they do, too. I mean, I spent a lot of time with these guys this week. They were giddy talking about the fact that they get a chance to block, and they love to block it, and how well they block it. I mean, they do a real good job of staying involved in a football game, even though they may not have a lot of catches in a game.
Now, watch these two wide receivers again. This play can only be as good as those two guys blocking. You don't have to kill anybody. Look at the position and the leverage.
Drive block by Dez. I mean, their wide receiver coach, Gunnar Brewer, coached Randy Moss at Marshall.
Okay.
And so he got a chance to show them all the good stuff, catching the pass and all of that. But, I mean, this right here is just want to. You don't teach this. This is want to. These guys get out of bed wanting to block. And that's why Oklahoma State offensively is one of the top 10 offenses in the country.
20 offensive plays, 21 points for Oklahoma State. NFL Network has the best NFL highlight show on TV. NFL Game Day, Sunday night at 11:30 Eastern. NFL Network football 24/7.
And you know, Sterling, I like to add one more thing to that. And that is when you can run option offensively and get the 11th man involved like they can with their quarterback.
Okay.
Now you've got an extra blocker in the run game. And when you combine that with wide receivers that will block,
yes,
you got a package.
Dan Bailey with the kickoff. His last two have gone into the end zone, and Indiana has taken a knee. This time they'll run it out. This is Thigpen, who can't even get up to the 15-yard line. Excellent tackle made by the special teams unit. Bryant Ward, a backup fullback, with his second tackle. Six plays, 54 yards for Zac Robinson, who runs it in for the touchdown at Oklahoma State. Three possessions, three touchdowns, 21-3. We're still in the first.
Don't we have kind of an opposite situation from a year ago? Last year, the Big Ten team jumped ahead and ended up losing in double overtime, 44-41.
Right.
Correct?
Yep.
Correct. Now we got it going the other way with the Big 12 team.
And field position, Indiana's average start, their own 19. Oklahoma State's average start, their own 42. Lewis and Indiana need some kind of offense just to give the defense a rest. Big Ten trying to find his way to the outside, and he gets cut down nicely by Marquis Fountain.
You cannot run sideline to sideline on this football team from where you are right now, because they're wide. Their defensive stance is getting wider and farther apart. So, I'm surprised, Mike, because I thought I'd see Indiana attack more downhill in the middle to try and get their quarterback on the outside, not the running back.
Second down for Indiana, and 10 yards to go. Thigpen converses with the quarterback, Lewis.
They're coming with six.
Lewis nearly intercepted as he tried to throw it out in the flat. Nathan Peterson nearly had the pick.
His mind's made up.
That's a zone blitz.
His mind's made up.
That's the defensive end, Nathan Peterson.
Yeah.
We talk about heating you up. Here is Peterson. He's supposed to come here. He's going to drop back here right underneath the route.
And Hardy's wide open.
He comes back off, covers the receiver, almost catches the football. And you're right, he made up his mind, Sterling.
Had his mind made up when he took the snap, because he missed the last wide route. So he's going to make up for it and give it to him on that.
Indiana's last eight offensive plays have netted 3 yards.
That's not good.
And great job by Nathan Peterson, the defensive end. And that's why they're losing the field position battle as well. Lewis has a running lane. Lewis has a much-needed first down for Indiana up to the 29-yard line.
It's amazing how big this guy is to take the beating that he takes. And as he runs his football, he takes another shot. And you and I got a chance to watch him in pregame, and we couldn't believe how small he is.
He's so skinny, he's got to run around in the shower to get wet. I mean, and you turn sideways, you can't see him.
I mean, but there he is taking another shot, bounces right back up. First down, Indiana. Offense stays on schedule.
I hate to be repetitive, but that's what this offense is going to need all day long to stay in this game.
Yes, they are.
Fisher, the motion man. Nothing doing for Thigpen as he gets tackled by Nathan Peterson.
This front seven's doing a great job of pressing the line of scrimmage. The zone read, by definition, is a lateral designed offense. And against a lateral offense, you got to press the line of scrimmage with your front seven. You got to push upfield.
That is the end of quarter number one here at the Insight Bowl in Tempe, Arizona. Sun Devil Stadium. The Oklahoma State Sooners are flying high. The Cowboys with a 21-3 lead here in the first quarter. Three possessions, three touchdowns for Zac Robinson and company. Welcome back to Tempe, Arizona, the Insight Bowl. Sun Devil Stadium, Oklahoma State, three possessions, three touchdowns. They lead Indiana 21-3 as we get set for the start of the second quarter. Bob Papa, Mike Mayock, Sterling Sharp, Kim Jones, so glad you can join us. Indiana on their first down plays, they're averaging 1.4 yards per first down play.
That's not very good.
And they convert 42% of their third down, which means they typically do a good job on first down, which isn't happening today.
They face a second down and long here to start the second. Lewis with some time. Lewis trying to find the edge. Lewis turns the corner. Lewis has a first down as he runs out of bounds at the 48-yard line.
And Sterling, we talked earlier about man-free coverage and the ability to scramble. That was the exact same situation. A free safety in the middle of the field. Watch what happens. Everybody else is man-to-man. Okay, so all the receivers got there. Look at the defensive backs and linebackers. They're all there's Donovan Woods, 25 yards down the field with his back turned. There's no secondary or tertiary help to stop the quarterback on scramble.
So a pair of first downs running for Lewis on this drive, and first and 10 for Indiana. Payton in the backfield as Fisher goes in motion. Fisher took the handoff. Fisher will lose some yardage. A loss of 7 on the play. Marquise Fountain was back there to make the tackle.
Wow. I mean, that was not the play they needed. I mean, the thing was is they tried to run the jet sweep before, a couple of plays before, and they probably should have given it. But right here, you know what? It's dead. Just hit it upfield. Go upfield.
And Nathan Peterson's the defensive end that provided the up-the-field pressure that forced them to turn around right back into Fountain. And what I sense here is they're looking for something to
searching.
Hang their hats
they're
on.
They're searching.
And what I think they need to do is drop back, throw the football, and let this kid create with his feet or his arm.
47 of Indiana's 79 yards have come on Lewis scrambles. Lewis on a second and long, being chased from behind. Lewis finds some room, but he's barely going to get back to the line of scrimmage. Great pursuit for the football by the front. Patrick Levine cleaned it up.
It's that lateral play that's allowing the Oklahoma State Cowboy defense to just move around and just push everything to the sideline. Look at him. Everybody's jetting to the sideline to try and beat him to that spot. And now you got a whole host of Cowboys over there and nowhere to go because the ball's supposed to come out in rhythm, come out quick. And now you got third and long, and you got your quarterback where this is not the down and distance that Indiana wants to be in all game.
They've had 2 third-and-10s, now a 3rd-and-17.
No free safety in the hole. Here it comes. Now they're going to go back into coverage.
Lewis, underneath to Means, makes the turn up the sideline. He's near the marker. It's close.
That's a good spot, Bob.
Boy,
that's
Andre Sexton had a chance, though, to make the play.
Yes.
Well short of the sticks.
That's a really good catch and run right there. So Indiana brings some athletes into this bowl game as well because this is a six-yard catch. And a 12-yard run. Ooh, I don't know if he got there, Bob.
Understand something. Andrew Means had 43 catches so far this season. 27 of them went for first down.
Okay.
And he had 29 stolen bases on the baseball team.
Man, I didn't have that one.
Yeah, he hit 369. He just showed his sort of Pete Rose-like slide there. He went head first.
Uh-oh, we might get a review, Sterling.
Yeah,
about.
Oh, I don't think he got there.
I was with you.
Oh, I mean, right on the Oklahoma State sideline as well.
It's being reviewed.
Jack Foliard, our referee, being challenged by Mike Gundy and Oklahoma State. Well, it was right in front of him.
I was just going to say, it was right on their sidelines. Let's see what happens here.
See where he goes out? Right there. Foot's out of bounds.
Can you see that, though?
Oh, yeah.
Is it Levine blocking?
Yeah, no.
Look, here you go. Here's a good one.
There you go, right here.
Let's see it. We'll freeze frame.
Out of bounds, right there.
There he is. He's out.
Whoa.
That's a good 4 yards short.
You sure about that?
The divot?
Yeah. Yeah, he's out. This toenail's out. He's out, Bob.
No, I thought I saw a divot in the field of play.
Great haircut, too.
I like that look.
I just like the fact that they went out and ran a little snag route by the receiver on the line of scrimmage, made it a 6-yard throw, and he turned it into what is being reviewed for a first down.
So you and I have this difference in vocabulary. That's a whip route for me and a snag route
snag,
for you.
Yeah, oh,
look
yeah.
And lean is what for you?
That's what we do on offense. What you guys do on defense, feel and fall.
Feel and fall.
Right.
He's out.
There.
Now, and the next foot certainly out, so either way.
He still doesn't make it.
He doesn't make it. However, I think if you're Bill Lynch, you've got to be thinking about going for it here. Okay, I think
really?
You're looking at a fourth down situation at about the 33-yard line,
really?
Fourth and two.
Doesn't it really depend on which foot they rule was out of bounds?
Yeah.
Because if it's the first
now
foot,
you're right.
It's about 4 yards. The second foot probably gives you a fourth and two.
Or are you asking Bill Lynch to go for it regardless of where there's fourth or four and two?
I'm typically fairly conservative being a coach's son.
Okay.
However, in this situation, down 21-3, where your defense hasn't stopped anybody yet.
Nope.
So I'm sitting here going, the field goal would be close to 50. And I got a good field goal kicker. But I need to score some points. I need to keep the defense off the field. So I think it's a difficult decision, but I'm going for it.
But they've lost the field position with all the three and outs. If you punt it here and you knock it out and save about the 10-yard line.
If you do, and if you don't, if you pick up 12 yards to the 20.
Well, if you get it out of bounds, your punter's supposed to
after
get it out of bounds. Here's the rule.
It was determined that the runner stepped out of bounds short of the line of gain at the 43-yard line. It will be fourth down and 1 yard at the 43-yard line.
Wait a minute, that's my bad. It's on the 43. I'm sorry. No, I was looking at the 33, so now you're punting.
But he's still going for it.
We'll go for it.
On the season, Will Lynch's squad 9 of 15 on fourth downs.
I go for it.
You're still going for
it
here?
I'm still going for it. I'm still, with my quarterback, I'm still going for it.
What's your best play here?
Well, I think they got it, in all honesty, it's fourth and about 1.5. I'm putting it in Kellen Lewis's hands right here.
Stay with your bread and butter. Go with the zone read.
Zone read hasn't gone anywhere today. Look at who's in the game.
They've got
Josiah Sears is in the game, not their zone read back.
So it's going to be sprint right.
It's going to be a
sprint right to the corner.
It's going to be a throw, and it's either going to be a choice in here or something up here.
Fourth and one for Indiana.
Roll right.
Fisher in motion.
Up the roll.
Lewis can't find Fisher.
And he had him.
I can't believe he threw it that quick. I'm rolling him just so he can keep it.
Wide open.
And I want him to keep it.
Kellen Lewis fouls on a fourth and one. Oklahoma State gets the ball back up big. Some of the fans at the inside bowl in the Bob Uecker seats on the little hill just outside of Sun Devil Stadium. Well, the fourth down play.
Now, keep
Sterling,
going.
You and I disagree.
Just keep it because you got here on your legs. Keep running. Keep going.
And I say he's open by 3 yards.
He is. I'm not discounting.
The play call was there executed.
No, he is. But you told me Kellen Lewis is probably the best zone read quarterback, which means his legs are really dynamite. Use your legs and get the first down.
So now Oklahoma State gets the football after the failure on fourth down. They've scored 3 touchdowns on 3 possessions. Savage takes the pitch and picks up a couple before he's run down by Matt Mayberry. Glad to be here at the Inside Bowl. For more, here's Kim Jones.
Thank you, Bob. This is the Inside Bowl, which means we're going to talk about Inside Enterprises. Joining me, CEO Rich Fennessy and Mark McGrath, the president. Rich, you're a Michigan State guy. I'm guessing you're pulling for the Big Ten team.
Well, you got to love the Big Ten, but both teams are looking strong. But the Big Ten is, you know, special.
And Mark, you went to the University of Ohio, so I don't even have to ask who you're rooting for, given that Terry Heppner was the coach.
True. As a Miami graduate, I'm a huge fan of Coach Hepp, and he has a great legacy, obviously, at Miami and Indiana, so just a big fan of his.
Why Insight is so committed to this bowl and being part of college football?
Really, for two reasons. I mean, first of all, we obviously love college football and just the association with the Big Ten, the Big 12. We're really proud of that. From a business perspective, just a great opportunity for us to build brand awareness and hopefully attract new clients to do business with Insight.
All right, speaking of brand awareness, educate those of us, what's Insight all about?
Insight is an IT solutions company. So we actually have offices in 23 countries around the world, and our job is quite simply is to help companies around the world run better through the help of IT technology.
I think that's right up Sterling Sharp's alley. Guys, thank you so much. Bob.
All right, thanks, Kim. Well, Zac Robinson was picked off by Nick Polk, but neutral zone infraction against Indiana.
Two neutral zone infractions that have hurt Indiana badly, and that one especially.
Wow. Oklahoma State keeps the ball. They have a 2nd and 3. Savage in a one-back set. Robinson under some pressure and gets it away incomplete. Good pressure put on Robinson by Jamie Kierlew.
You know, Zac Robinson is dying to throw an interception in. Now, he just threw one, and you got the neutral zone infraction. And then right there, you know, you got nothing. Throw the ball in the stands. You come back, it's 3rd and 3, and you run the football.
Got Tracy Porter back in the football game. One of the top corners in the country. Good to see him running around.
Yes, I hope he's okay. Yes, it is.
So Oklahoma State now faces a 3rd and 3.
So far, they've been an option team in these situations. Looking over to the sideline. Remember, Zac told us yesterday, just once, he wants to make his own call.
I tried to get him to wave him off.
Told you. Here comes option.
Robinson with a 1st down and plenty more. Inside the 40 and knocked out at the 37-yard line. Nick Polk came over and made the tackle.
Now, that play was so open that the right tackle, Brady Bond, was 10 yards down the field looking for somebody to block.
I mean,
there was nobody there.
Did a real good job of just hitting. I mean, they are running their offense definitely on schedule. I mean, look at that.
There's the right tackle.
He's stretching.
Quarterback's behind him.
Now there's nowhere to go.
That's how open it is.
Wow. We'll keep the chains moving. 1st and 10.
Look to the sideline.
Call him off, Zac.
Wave him off.
Wave him off, Zac.
I set part of the fullback. Bryant on the receiver screen. Gets a block on the outside. Bryant.
How about that block?
And we'll get a flag on the play, a late flag, and maybe that block was too good. Woo. Darius Bowman.
Darius Bowman, man. I'm definitely in his fan club right now. And like I said, spent a lot of time with the Oklahoma State receivers this week, and we had a lot of fun talking technique, old school, new school, but.
Ooh. Wow. Old school that time.
Wow. That was old school, yeah. Very good, Bob. Yeah, that wow. Right there, man. Just love to block.
Here comes Bowman on Porter out here. He's got his hand.
He's got his shoulder pad.
Right. He's got the hand outside the framework of the body.
I mean, right there, the left hand is what gets the holding call.
But you love the aggression. I love the aggression.
Early in the year, he was leading the team in pancake block.
I'm going to tell you right now, if I'm the head coach, I'm not on him at all. I'm going to look him in the eye and say, Darius, keep doing that. Great job.
You are?
Yeah, I am.
He blocks like a receiver from the Big Ten.
Great block, yeah, like a receiver from LSU.
Yeah, he does.
LSU is the other team whose receivers always block.
So first down, Bowman goes in motion. Let's see if they feed him the ball. Robinson. Bowman.
There you go. Good call, Bob.
Carrington on the tackle. Well, they did it earlier after Bryant got called for the penalty. They went through from the end zone. Now they go to Bowman.
So I get a penalty, move us back, and then I get the ball. I'm starting to sense a trend here. Okay, I got it. So let me jump offside and then get the – I mean, does a really nice job. He pushes off right here, Mike. Does he put – watch, extend the hands right here.
Yep.
Extend the hands.
Yep.
Pushed off. Makes the catch. Now go and finish. Finish.
Coming back to the football.
I mean, technically, just
love to come back to the
yes,
football.
I
catch
do.
With your hand.
Yes, I do. Now go finish. Pick up the first down. Nice job.
It's team retribution. First and 10, Oklahoma State trying to build upon a 21-3 lead. Savage in a one-back set. Bowman in motion. Bryant to the top of your screen. Savage. Trying to reverse his field. Savage does not as a flag comes in. Nice tackle made by Leslie Majors for a loss of about 6.
But you're going to have to get the whole posse there. You're not tackling these guys one-on-one in space. I mean, they do a great job. I never saw that hole. I don't know how he found it.
No flag on the play. Play was legal. Second down.
Dantrell Savage makes a lot of people miss Sterling. I watched a bunch of tape on this kid. Quick feet. I don't know what his long speed is, but he's really quick with his feet. Doesn't see anything, doesn't like it out there. We got our guy Austin Thomas forcing him back. Now watch Leslie Majors, 28 flash. They told me Leslie Majors at 175 pounds is one of the toughest kids on their team defensively. Was a high school wrestler, believe it or not.
No, that's why.
Plays corner.
Oh, that's why.
Cowboys face a 2nd and 16 now. At the Indiana 31. Robinson, Bryant fights his way to the 20. Down to the 19-yard line. Boy, he's pretty good with yards after contact.
The way it's his body, Bob. He has a tremendous body that will allow him to absorb hits. He's solid. And he wants to look like Bowman, he said. So he's going to stay in the weight room this offseason. But that's what it is. The ability to finish. Once you make the catch, now I got to get that yards after the catch and make sure I get my shoulder pads on the other side of the defender's shoulder pads.
And with all the bubble screens they throw to the wide receivers, you can see why they want to block.
Yeah.
Because you're going to get yours as long as you help your buddy.
Only the 2nd, 3rd down for Oklahoma State. They converted on a 3rd and 1 earlier. This is a 3rd and 5 at the 20. Savage to the right of Robinson. Bowman's in a slot right. Robinson, Bryant near the marker, and he fights for the first down as he shook the tackle of Tracy Porter.
Another physical move. Dez Bryant.
He's a special individual, and I enjoy just listening to him talk about technique. I mean, it's a hitch route, and now I got the first down. Now, whatever I get after that is on me. Did a real good job of weight down, running a good route in transition, and then once he made the catch, get yourself the extra yard because you've already got the first down.
He needed 5, he got 6. Bryant split to the right of the formation, top of your screen. Bowman in motion. Bowman set him up. Looking for the tight end, and Pettigrew made the catch, but he was out of bounds.
Uh-oh. All right, he did. He was out of bounds. That was impressive, though.
How about that catch, right?
But that was impressive by a 6'6 guy. That was impressive.
Now, Bowman cleared the area, and they come with the throwback into the corner, like Sterling said. Did he hold it?
Yeah, he holds on to it.
It doesn't matter, obviously, but the kid at 6'6", 260, he's a junior, and there are an awful lot of good tight ends in this country, but Sterling, he's as good as any of them.
I agree, Mike, and I mean, just technically sound, soft hands, big kid that can move, silky smooth, a running route. He's open again.
Second and 10, Robinson to the end zone, and Von Bowman.
He had the wheel route open. He forced it inside the Bowman, but the wheel route in the corner of the end zone was wide open. Nice job by Nick Paul pulling back inside, making a play.
Bowman played on the basketball team last spring. Yeah. Tried to use some of his leaping ability to make that one.
Look at the arms. Look at those arms. I mean, that's a wide receiver. Look at those.
6'4", 220.
I think I know some NFL teams that are looking at him as a potential H-back also because of his tough.
Oh, yeah. Like Shannon used to be.
Yep, exactly.
I'm not saying Shannon was that tough.
Third and 10.
Oh, he's open.
Wide open.
Robinson to the end zone. And easily to Bowman for the touchdown.
Great play action.
Yes, it was.
He had more than one guy open.
Yeah. I said he's open. I meant all of them are open.
It was like a deli. There was a smorgasbord of wide open receivers.
Gee whiz.
Great play action fake.
They go inside, set up the block.
Look at everybody going that way, and he's coming across the formation, wide open. Porter doesn't see him back on the inside. That's stealing right there.
Second touchdown pass for Zac Robinson. Extra point by Dan Bailey is right through. So four offensive possessions for Oklahoma State. And the Cowboys are riding high. They lead it 28-3 as Adarius Bowman gets the last touchdown. As evening falls in Tempe, Arizona, glad you can join us for the Insight Bowl here on NFL Network. Oklahoma State and Adarius Bowman with four offensive possessions, and they have four touchdowns. Thigpen will run it out a yard deep for Indiana. And he gets cut down at the 20-yard line. So once again, Indiana will start deep in their own territory. More from Sun Devil Stadium after this timeout. Oklahoma State goes 57 yards in 11 plays. They have a 28-3 lead. Indiana with a first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. There have been 57 offensive snaps in the game for two teams combined, 42 on the Indiana side of the field. His pass intended for James Bailey, incomplete. Oklahoma State's on a roll. Kim Jones has more.
Hey, Bob, I got a newsflash for you. This is a very happy Oklahoma State sideline. Adarius Bowman and Dez Bryant sharing a nice moment. Mike Gundy actually came over, shook both of their hands. They shared a laugh, and then Bowman showed he's a smart guy. He left his receiver and went down to thank his offensive line for giving Zac Robinson time, guys.
Everything is clicking right now. Offensively and defensively.
For Oklahoma State,
Oklahoma
you're right.
State. I mean,
yes, sir.
Especially after that opening drive. I mean, what's the psyche of Indiana right now? Second and 10 for the Hoosiers at their own 20. Lewis.
You know what I'm really liking from Oklahoma State is the way they're disguising pre-snap on Kellen Lewis.
Offense, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Look at Adarius having fun.
And to go back to Bob's question, the psyche of Indiana is, it's like Mike said early on, they're searching. It's almost like they're not sure about the zone read. They're not sure about throwing the football. It's just, it seems like it's an offense that has a lot of uncertainty.
And off an incomplete pass, you get called for a delay of game.
Right. Which is amazing in itself. I mean, because you got a bunch of guys milling around because they're not comfortable being in this situation.
And now you spread it wide, two by two, two wide receivers on each side, and here comes Oklahoma State coming. Look at all the movement with their defenders.
Second and 15. Lewis under some pressure. Lewis is going to tuck it down and run. Lewis to the 22-yard line, run out of bounds by Donovan Woods. You know, what about Hardy?
Gray Fisher would still be running right now if the quarterback looks down the middle of the field. He's still running. And not only Fisher, I think Ray Fisher, excuse me, but James Hardy, man, has got to be saying, okay, I'm getting ready to pull a Terrell Owens, or I'm getting ready to pull a Randy Moss, and that is, I'm your guy, I've been your guy all season, and now we get into a game like this where you should be coming to me and you're not.
You got, and I really think Kellen Lewis is confused pre-snap based on what he's seeing out there. Look at all the stemming in and out. He doesn't know whether it's man or zone. All of a sudden, bang, it's zone.
On third down, Lewis this time able to get it to James Bailey. He's got a first down looking for more, and Bailey up to midfield and Russell down at the 49-yard line by Ricky Price.
Really like the patience that time of Kellen Lewis. Sterling just made the point that you got to find some open guys. Now, this time, he waits. Here he comes open deep across the middle, in between the zone defenders. Now you become a running back. Pick up a picket fence, make the cut, get up the field, and finish.
And that's a very nice job right there.
Longest play for Indiana. First and 10 at the 49 of Oklahoma State. Big pen into the line, picks up about four.
And you know what? When you get a play like that, I've always been under the assumption that when you get a big play like that, you want to play faster. Get in and out of the huddle. How many plays can we run at this team? And I mean, I'm looking at the Indiana offense, and they're kind of just, you know, moving around, you know, getting a feel for the spot they want to stand in. There's no excitement. There's no let's get after these guys. It's just, it's like, okay, you know, we'll work our way out of it. Eventually, you know, Kellen will make a play. Don't see any enthusiasm from this football team trying to get back in this game.
Second and seven for Lewis. Under pressure from Woods. Lewis is going to run it. Lewis shoved out of bounds by Quentin Moore at the 40-yard line. There is a flag on the play, though. Back in the offensive backfield.
Not in a good place. That looks like it's going to be a hold.
And here's a football team now that's going to start to look for somebody to get them out of this. They're going to start to look around and go, okay, now all year it's been 82, and all year it's been 15. You know, I stopped talking so the official could be heard. His equipment obviously doesn't
work.
Well, it's a hold against Indiana, no matter how you.
However,
hold's a hold.
But I mean, this football team is going to start to look for someone to help them get out of this hole. Now, is it going to be head coach Bill Lewis? Who's it going to be that's going to help get this offense on track, get this football team on track, so they can get back in this game?
See, the problem is now you're going empty. You got five wides in the game, no back, no tight end, and you're not a good pass protection team. How many will Oklahoma State bring?
Get it out quickly. And across the field is Ray Fisher. Short stick knocked down at the 42-yard line. Terrence Anderson on the tackle. And another flag.
Can't we all just get along? We want to win this bowl game too, guys.
All the play of game 13.
Personal foul, that helps Indiana.
We can get the rest mic working.
Probably don't want Coach Gundy's mic working right now.
Oh, he knows who it is.
Dead ball personal foul. Oklahoma State.
Number 53, he said?
53 would be Seb Clemens.
I think that's the only way Zeb's getting his name on this telecast.
First and 10.
For all the wrong reasons, I don't think it was him.
I don't think it was him either. 56.
Maurice Cummings.
All right, here we go, offense. Offense now, to start to move around. Let's get the ball to Hardy.
Five balls have gone his way, one catch. And Lewis fumbles the snap, gets it off to the fullback, and Brian Payton is just flattened.
And you know who flattened them was the guy we had some fun with yesterday, Jeremy Nathan, who is playing in his fourth bowl game for Oklahoma State.
Right.
And also, I enjoyed talking to the kid yesterday. He was suspended by Mike Gundy 2 years ago. Almost didn't come back and play football. A little bit emotional yesterday with us about what football means to him and the opportunity to come back that Coach Gundy gave him.
A guy grateful to the game of football for what it's taught him and done for him. I mean, I was with you, Mike, and, you know, listening to him describe it, man, it was very emotional.
Second and 13, Lewis under pressure, and he just throws it away as Donovan Woods came charging in. Well, we spoke with Jeremy yesterday, and he talked about his comeback.
The main thing was just not giving up. That's where I wanted to be. I was recruited by other schools, and, you know, that's where I wanted to be. And I told Coach, I said, I made a mistake, and I just really want to get back on the team. So he gave me the opportunity to.
You know, he walked back on. He had to walk on. Coach made him
right.
walk on.
Uh-huh.
He worked at Payless. He had the birth of his young son, Cal, he said really made him grow up in a hurry. He wanted to be a role model for his son. I asked him yesterday, you know, if this is your last football game ever, what's it mean to you? And he basically was, you know what? It's great for me. It's great for my family. It's made me grow up. And gosh, I just hope that he gets a chance to play in the NFL and live it a little bit longer.
I agree.
Indiana has called the timeout, trying to get back in this one with 7:27 to go in the second. Welcome back to the Insight Bowl in Tempe, Arizona. Oklahoma State with four touchdowns on four offensive possessions. They lead Indiana 28-3. Hoosiers, though, on a drive. Another third and long for Indiana. Lewis over the middle. He's got Hardy for the first down inside the 15 and knocked down at the 14-yard line. Parrish Cox on the tackle.
Now, the offensive line did an outstanding job because they got pressure and they got a little movement up front. Number four loops around right there. You see him coming on the blitz and then a beautiful throw and catch. Look at him reach out and just snag that ball. And now he's trying to put it in the end zone. Beautiful throw by Kellen. Just stepped in there. Great catch by Hardy. First and first down, headed towards the end zone. Nice play by OU, by IU, excuse me.
Best drive so far for Indiana since the opening drive of the game when they had to settle for three. Peyton, the tailback, takes the handoff. He finds some room. Peyton knocked down at the 3-yard line. Quinton Moore saved the touchdown.
And that's what I thought we were going to see early on, Mike. I thought they were going to attack Oklahoma State in the middle of that defense because that's where they were the softest. And I mean, right here, offensive line starting
right
to come
there.
Alive.
Look at the look back block right there.
Starting to come alive a little bit. So now the offensive line gets it going. I think this Hoosier offense is going to get going. I mean, very nice blocking at the point of attack, opening up a hole. I mean, that's great. He hits it.
First and goal. Hardy split to the top of your screen. He had 16 touchdown catches, second most in the NCAA this year. They give it off on the inside and nothing there for Peyton. Patrick Levine, the middle linebacker, filled the hole nicely.
They had a slant going to the field, so that play was dead from the start. Because as soon as he started left, everybody's coming hard to their running and just blow it up in the backfield. I mean, one guy comes through so clean, he falls.
That was Patrick Levine, the inside linebacker, on a twist stunt.
Yes.
The tackle's coming down, the linebacker coming
around
in a twist or X stunt. Wasn't picked up cleanly, and now you're back on the 4-yard line. You almost feel like you have to throw it to get it in the end zone still.
And who are you going to throw it to?
Well, you got a 6'7" guy out there on the edge, but they're playing 3x2 on top of him.
Second and goal. Lewis under pressure to the end zone, and Hardy can't reel it in. Vicky Price on the coverage.
Third down.
You and I have been sitting up here saying he needs to take this game over.
Yep.
Why doesn't he work back towards the quarterback?
You know, I think frustration has set in on him, and he's not really sure when they're coming to him. Because right now just take one step and you got to catch. You take one step towards,
exactly.
You got to catch. And, you know, that's one of those things that you expect the guy that's had this much success to be able to do. I mean, but.
And Ricky Price, the safety, did a nice job.
Yes.
But at 6'7", you got to shield him like a weak side rebounder.
You're exactly right, Mike.
12th play of the drive. Third and goal at the 4. Lewis checks down. Big pen for the touchdown.
Beautiful play. Hey, in space. Got a guy in space. Got a guy there. Got to make the tackle. He doesn't make the tackle. IU in the end zone for a touchdown.
You can't go low like that making a tackle.
On a guy that exposed, trying to make a catch out of the backfield. You just go up and hit him in the mouth. I mean, you're looking in the backfield. You got it. Go get it.
Go get it.
So here comes 16, Parrish Cox. You can't drop your shoulder pad that early and make it that easy. You got to man up on him, helmet on his helmet, and drive him back.
Marcus Thigpen's third touchdown catch of the season gets Indiana back in this game with 5:35 to go in the half. Austin Starr for the extra point. Snap is good, and Starr rips it through.
I mean, you know what? You get the ball out of the quarterback's hands, does a very good job. The defense is set. Now you got a guy there, make the tackle. If you don't make the tackle, you give up a touchdown, and that's what Oklahoma State did.
Coming up at the half, Paul Burmeister and Steve Mariucci with bowl scores and highlights, and they'll remember coach Terry Heppner. One of the captains, Josiah Sears, will never forget.
He always told us, don't quit, whatever you're doing, keep playing, don't quit. And when it came down to it, when he had his adversity and his struggles with the cancer and the tumor, he didn't quit. You know, he kept pushing forward. And you know, I look back at that, and, you know, he preached something, but he really lived it. And, you know, I'll never forget that.
You don't want to miss that special feature at halftime on Coach Heppner, as you got some of the thoughts from Josiah Sears. And I'll tell you what, Indiana hasn't quit in this ball game as they come back with an impressive drive.
Look at his hair. He just had a...
Yeah, that's not the haircut he had.
No, yesterday he had that different look going.
A little mohawk.
Yeah. Josiah. He was really an interesting kid. I liked him.
Thompson on the return for Oklahoma State. Now Darius Thompson works his way across the 30. And a good return up to the 37-yard line, giving Oklahoma State good field position from an hour before kickoff. Some of the Indiana fans, especially those students behind that sign, chanting, Terry Heppner.
Yeah. I thought his wife, Jane, was really impressive earlier with Kim. I'll tell you, he energized what is perceived to be a basketball school.
That's true.
He got people thinking football. He brought new traditions in, the walk, the rock, defend the rock at Memorial Stadium. After every home game that they win, they sing and dance with the Marching 100 band. He's got them being proud to be football players in Indiana.
Every Oklahoma State offensive possession has started past the 30, and this time Robinson finds another tight end, Justin Waller, who makes his first catch of the season.
And this play action game's getting too easy.
It's getting way too easy.
Left guard, watch the little block he pulls out. There's the block on the edge, throws it right down the middle of the field. And when you can run the football as effectively as they have, Sterling,
good point.
It's just too easy on play action.
32 offensive plays, 11 have gone for 10 or more yards for Oklahoma State. Robinson keeps it this time. Robinson inside the 35 to the 33. Curlew on the tackle.
You cannot continue to allow this Oklahoma State offense to skip it down. You can't let them go first down. You can't let them go second down, first. You have to keep them, get them off the field, get them to third and long. And, I mean, this defense is going to have to do something. You can't just line up in your base defense and expect that you can man up and get them off the field.
Give it off to the freshman Hunter, and he pounds inside the 30 to the 25-yard line.
Just skipped it down again. It's second down and two, going back to first down. You can't allow this offense to continue to skip it down after you just went, you know, down the field and got a touchdown.
Mike, what about Kendall Hunter? I mean, here's a kid, a freshman, who comes in. He's averaging 6.5 yards a carry.
61 yards a game. You know, when you lose a guy like Savage after this year, they've got the true freshman who's a bookend, very similar to Savage. Very quick and catches the ball well.
First and 10 at the 25-yard line of Indiana for Oklahoma State. Cowboys, 4 offensive possessions, 4 touchdowns.
Corner blitz.
Robinson keeps it. Robinson carrying Thomas to the first down marker.
Okay, so I said you can't just allow this team to keep skipping it down. You got to do something. And what do?
They went corner blitz, which is an aggressive defensive play, and they ran option right into the corner blitz. So what? There goes the ride and the glide. Here comes the corner. He misses the tackle. Comes through unblocked. Leslie Majors, your coach has made a pretty good call there.
Great call.
You got to close the deal. You run an option right at a corner blitz, and you pick up 10 yards.
Wow. Execution.
Skipped it down again. First down to first down.
Ball spotted at the 14. Robinson keeps it. Curlew keeps the gain to a half yard.
One of the few times today where everything was covered on option.
Yes, it was.
The ride was covered.
Yep.
The quarterback was covered. The pitch man was covered. Assignment football like you draw it up on the blackboard.
Unfortunately for Indiana, those plays have been few and far between defensively.
Right.
Maybe they can force a turnover. Get a little spark defensively.
They need it.
Second and 10 at the 14. Hunter the tailback. And the left side of the offensive line moved.
Well, first, let's see whether or not the defensive lineman was in the neutral zone, which caused Pettigrew to jump.
He moved first, yeah. So it's got to be on the defense.
Line judge is pointing at the defense. Greg Middleton, you see him, number 92.
We haven't called his name yet today.
Dead ball offside on the defense, number 92.
Now we did.
Player was in the neutral zone, causing the offensive player to react. By rule, offside. 5 yards, second down.
16 sacks, leads the nation in sacks. Well, here he is. He clearly is in the neutral zone. Pettigrew and the tackle, Okung, both jump. Hey, if you move, I'm moving.
On you.
80% of Oklahoma State offensive snaps have been in plus territory.
That's amazing.
Hunter fights his way down to the 3. He rolled off a defender. They'll spot him at the 2. Middleton and Majors.
It's amazing how this offense looks spread. You know, it looks perimeter.
Yep.
But it does a really good job running at you downhill, too. I mean, you really have to be careful because it comes downhill pretty good.
And here they are real quick. Look at them. They set real quick. And you got to be aware of their position grouping because they sneak a tight end in there on you all the time.
First and goal. Robinson moves the pile forward. And they'll spot it at the 1 yard line. Robinson has run for a touchdown. He's thrown for 2. Savage has the other touchdown run for Oklahoma State.
And Bob, what they do, what Mike Gundy loves to do with that quick count, get him up on the line of scrimmage, and they go unbalanced. So you don't have time to recognize that it's an unbalanced
right,
line.
Right.
And if you don't adjust, it's an easy short yardage game.
They just keep attacking. They get off the bus attacking. Oh, you know, get a playoff because we're going to stand at the line just so we can attack you some more. They attack you the entire game.
Second and goal. Robinson again. And Zac Robinson has his second rushing touchdown of the ball game. 5 possessions, 5 offensive touchdowns for Oklahoma State.
Wow. I mean, Bill Lynch has got to be asking, you know, what can we do to slow this juggernaut down? I mean, they got outstanding skill guys. They spread you and run the football with power. I mean, what do you got to do? I mean, unbalanced line right there, which you just talked about. Run a quarterback sneak right at it. I mean, just.
The problem, Sterling, is that
play's being reviewed as to whether he broke the plank.
Okay.
Let's take a look right here. Where's the football?
Helmet's across. Where's the football?
It
looks like everything's across, doesn't it?
I mean, Dez knew it was a touchdown. Look at Dez.
And I'm trusted Pettigrew.
Pettigrew's blocking, and he's like, hey, it's a touchdown, right?
Quarterback's in the end zone.
Hey, it's a touchdown, right?
Yeah, that's not even close.
And look at Mike. Look at Mike. Look where Mike Gundy is. Mike. Look at Mike.
Aren't Mike's 10 yards on the field going, you got to be kidding me.
Come on.
Look at him. You kidding me?
Mike's like, I got shades on and I can see it.
He is inside the numbers, folks.
Is that like the coaching box in college football?
He is inside the numbers.
And after the booth review, it's pulled a touchdown. Usually when the quarterback's in the end zone,
yeah,
with the ball.
Yeah. You don't want that guy upset.
No.
I mean, I heard that guy, when he gets upset, he can put it on you pretty good. So you don't want Mike Gundy upset. He's one of those guys that lets you have it, you know. How old is Mike Gundy anyway?
Dan Bailey is on for the extra point.
Because for a young guy,
40 years of age,
intense, energetic.
I mean, he
class of 90 at OSU.
Played with two
Hall of Fame tailbacks.
Yeah.
Partly explains why his passing numbers were so
good. Yeah.
The all-time leading pass in Oklahoma State history as Bailey bangs in an extra point. Now Zac Robinson has run the offense for Oklahoma State to perfection.
You know what? He's a better athlete than people give him credit for. He drops it in. Nice catch by our guy, Dez Bailey. There's the ride, the glide, the side. They're both wide receivers with great blocks.
Yep.
He runs a 4.5 40. He throws the ball with authority, wide open. I could have made that throw. And then, of course, the quarterback sneak. So what you see with Zac Robinson, I really think he solidified this offensive team. Because remember, Sterling,
yes,
Bobby Reed was their quarterback a year ago.
Yep.
This kid steps in. Week three, they get beat by Troy, and he's gotten better each week. And now they've got a kid that's going to be special for the next couple of years.
I agree, Mike. I just think that, you know, he fits what they need from this offense from the quarterback position. I don't think he'll ever run for 1,000 yards in a season, but I think that he's very decisive with the football. He knows when to take off with it, does a good job on the zone read of understanding when to give it and going through his progressions and his reads, and he's a guy you can trust.
21-year-old redshirt sophomore from Littleton, Colorado, a business major. And he has guided his team to a 35-10 lead. Bailey on the kickoff. James Bailey for Indiana from his own 8. And once again, barely gets to the 20-yard line. Tremendous kick coverage by Oklahoma State as well. The path to the draft is on NFL Network. Don't miss the 2008 Under Armour Senior Bowl. Top college seniors play for NFL coaches. This all-star matchup Saturday, January the 26th, only on NFL Network. I was talking with Mike Nolan this past week, and he enjoyed coaching the Senior Bowl.
Yeah.
And he said, hey, if I get the opportunity again, I'm going to have to talk differently about certain guys because people are saying it's fixed. I get good draft picks out of this, getting to work with the kids, coaching.
It's my favorite week. My favorite week of the year because you get to see good on good, full live one-on-one situations, 4 practices in a row.
Lewis with the pass to Hardy.
Lewis's pass complete to Hardy.
Wow. You know, we talk about Zac Robinson for guys that threw for 2,500 yards, Sterling, and then also rushed for over 750. He threw for 2,522, over 750. He did it in less plays than either of the other two quarterbacks, LeFever or Tebow.
Yep.
Means with the catch, and he's got a first down. So you're right, you get to see the best against the best.
Love the Senior Bowl. And the beauty of it is it's coached, as you said, by the NFL staffs. It's set up for NFL evaluation of individual players.
Yep.
So what's it mean? It means it's the best corners and the best against the best wide receivers,
yes,
the best O-line against the best D-line, and it's full live all week. It's wonderful.
Flag in the play. Lewis looking to throw it. It's incomplete. We'll check on the flag.
That should be home.
Joe's got to be a little bit careful because I think I remember in 06, people were worrying about Matthias Kiwanuka. He was kind of getting manhandled a little bit, but he's turned out to be a pretty good NFL player. Let's get a look at the hold there.
He didn't really mean to grab him.
Roger Saffold.
He's sorry. I mean, if you say you're sorry, you should not.
Holding on the offense number 61. 10-yard penalties from the previous spot. First down.
Holding on Ben Weiss, the center.
Trying to protect his quarterback. He got beat by a great move at the point. And then, you know what? Instead of yelling, look out, he grabs a guy to try and slow him down. And you hope the umpire doesn't see it. He didn't. The referee threw the flag because he saw it.
The right side of the Indiana line is 3 fifth-year seniors who are not real athletic. They're try-hard, tough guys, but they're a little bit overmatched athletically.
Yes.
Oklahoma State has provided a lot of scrapes against this Indiana offense. First and 20. Lewis got some time. Nobody's open.
He's wide open.
And now he's got somebody open, and he overthrows Bailey.
Ooh.
Wow. Nobody was open for so long that somebody got open.
I think Bailey should have kept drifting.
Why did he come back to the football?
I thought he should have kept drifting. And then it was a little high throw, but.
And let Sterling, you were a wide receiver. I was a defensive back. Let's talk a little bit about scramble rules. When a quarterback scrambles, okay?
Right.
Now, what do you do?
Keep drifting. Because I got Hardy is right down underneath right there. So I got to keep
Wow. And the hands came down.
Yeah, the hands came down. That was a big hit coming, and the hands came down. Ricky Price was laying the leather right there. So, but yeah, you just keep drifting on that play, and you walk in the end zone.
Second and 20. Lewis gets some time. Lewis trying to find Hardy, but good coverage downfield.
I think a lot of
Jacob Lacy.
A lot of the throws that we're asking Kellen Lewis to make right now are out of character throws for him. This is not what he is built or cut out to do. I think, asking him to put it in tight spots, throw on the sideline right there. They're running, vertical seams, the inside receiver going down the middle of the field where you need a stick back shoulder throw. I think we might be asking him to do something that is out of character for him.
I watched a lot of tape, and I saw him make some nice vertical throws, but you're right, Sterling. From a sophistication viewpoint offensively, I don't think they throw the back shoulder thing.
No.
They don't have that.
No.
Third and 20. 10 throws to Hardy. 3 completions. Lewis zips one left short of the sticks as he finds Lewis.
Pretty good arm. I mean, the kid has a live arm. He's
sure.
He's a sophomore. He's only 180 pounds. If he's, that's what he's listed. He doesn't look.
He's not 180 pounds.
He's got good arm strength for a young kid that's as skinny as he is. He just needs to be a little more consistent with his ability and his accuracy in the pass.
And recognition, because a lot of the throws he could make, the ball should come out a lot quicker. And you see him drop back, and there's a lot of bounce, bounce, bounce before it comes out. Whereas, some of those throws that he should be making down the seams inside by the hashes, as soon as your back foot hits, that ball's got to be on its way.
Oklahoma State has called the timeout with 1:06 to go. Indiana fans a little bewildered, their first bowl appearance since 1993 at the Independence Bowl. And right now, Oklahoma State is just pounding them. 5 touchdowns on 5 offensive possessions.
And it's really important right now. What are we looking at? A 4th and 11 here.
Points is the biggest deficit of this season. And they lost to Michigan State. So they do have some firepower. Indiana does have firepower. They do.
Good punt by Hines. Fair catch called for by Bryant at the 26-yard line. It's not normal where a team gets to 35 points in the first half. There's no turnovers.
That's true.
No turnovers.
It's a good point.
That's how good their offense has been.
Really been that good. And they've done a good job of showing enough run that when they do play action pass, Indiana believes it. And so you have guys wide open running through your secondary, and their quarterback has done a fantastic job of being decisive with the football.
Patriot-esque right now, offensively. Give it to the freshman again, Hunter. And he gets almost 9 on first down.
And let's see how aggressive Oklahoma State is offensively here. Mike Gundy, he pretty much always has the pedal to the floor.
Okay, got all the bullets in the gun to use them.
Run the draw, and look, quick snap option.
Look at Robinson. Carrington on the tackle, but after he gets the first down, it stops the clock with 31 seconds.
On the attack. And now what you're doing is you're going to spread them out and get some of these athletes at wide receiver one-on-one.
And look at that bottom of the screen. We got a one. Well, safety's coming over the top now.
Robinson with some time. Fastball. He completes it to Seth Newton.
Dez Bryant still has his arms up, wondering why it didn't come to him.
He'd still be running if
they were in a cover two, and Tracy Porter didn't even touch him on the redirect.
He
just let him right outside.
He should have jumped offside. And he'd get the next play.
See if they go back to that. 20th first down here in the first half. Robinson looks left this time, looks for Bryant, and the pass is intercepted.
Great catch.
What an interception by Nick Polk. He had one earlier, negated because of a penalty. This time he gets one
officially.
Now this time, Tracy Porter did redirect the wide receiver, which gave Nick Polk the free safety
Very
the opportunity to come over top.
You're exactly right, and forced him back inside to where his help was.
See?
Good job forcing him inside where his help is now. You're closer to the safety, and that's a great catch with contact by a guy that can play some wide receiver.
Yeah, don't forget that he had 32 catches a year ago as a wide receiver. He got moved in the spring because they didn't have a lot of defensive backs, and Zac Robinson got a little aggressive there, didn't he?
Well, they saw the same game we saw, which meant, you know, Dez Bryant was open, and they didn't get him the ball early, and they tried to come back to him.
So at the half, Indiana, and head coach Bill Lynch head to the locker room on the downside of a 35-10 score. One mistake by Zac Robinson, the late pick, but he has played a marvelous first half. Coming up at the half, Paul Burmeister and Steve Bariucci with bowl scores and highlights, and they'll remember coach Terry Heppner coming up at the half. Mike Gundy's squad with a big lead. He's with Kim.
Thank you, Bob. Mike, five possessions, five first touchdowns. Can you draw it up better than that?
Well, we've been fortunate. Our guys are running the ball really well. Zach's played well. We're getting some blocks up front. So if we just continue to play hard, we've got some skill guys that make plays. Defensively, we played pretty good, slowing them down a little bit.
How do you make sure your players don't human nature it and take it, put off the pedal in the second half?
Well, I think us coaches, we got to stay on them. And these guys have a lot of pride, and they've enjoyed being around each other. I've said that all week. And so they know they got to come out and play hard in the second half.
Thanks, coach.
Thank you.
Ken, the only mistake came late in the half as Zac Robinson got intercepted. But right now it's all Oklahoma State. They lead it at the half, 35-10. We'll check in with Paul and Coach Mariucci coming up next. To the Insight Bowl in Tempe, Arizona. Oklahoma State with a 35-10 lead over Indiana at the half. Bob Popple along with Mike Mayock and Sterling Sharp. And take a look at this first half. For the first time this season, Oklahoma State goes five consecutive possessions with a touchdown to go out to a 35-point lead. And they've just been dominant, and they've been led by their quarterback, haven't they, Mike?
Yeah, and I think he's a perfect fit for what they do from a scheme perspective. And he's only a sophomore, but he's got the thing down. Play action pass, that wide open. We've been talking about him all day. And then, of course, the options. Your wide receivers run the football. It makes it easier for that 11th man, Zac Robinson. Wide open on play action at Darius Bowman. Quick count, quarterback sneak. Everything they've called has worked. And I guess the loss of Larry Fedora, the offensive coordinator, didn't really hurt too much with Mike calling the play.
Mike Gundy has done a great job with that. The number that scares me on these first half stats, first downs, 20-10. When you look at Oklahoma State and those 20 first downs, they skipped a lot of downs going first down, first down, first down. And that's something that the Indiana defense has got to get control of to get back in this football game.
Believe it or not, Oklahoma State's the team that has the only turnover, and it came late in the first half as Robinson was picked off late. Now, last year at the Insight Bowl, Texas Tech overcame a 31-point deficit, and they won 44-41, the largest comeback in bowl history. Does Indiana have it in?
I hope so, and I think they throw the football well enough. I think Hardy's a big enough target and has proven himself all year that they can do it. I just think they got to come out firing. First of all, their defense has got to stop Oklahoma State's offense on this possession.
And that's the problem. Everybody wants to talk about you got to go score a bunch of points to come back. You better stop them. That's how comebacks start. You got to play defense.
Oklahoma State with the football. Darius Thompson on the return. Thompson to the sideline. Flag on the play as he's run out by Austin Starr. So we'll check on the flag. This is the most points scored in a bowl game by Oklahoma State since the Holiday Bowl in 1988 when they beat Wyoming 62-14.
Number 20 on the return team. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down.
And how does Indiana dig out of this? Kim Jones, do you have an answer?
Thank you, Bob. I just did talk to Bill Lynch. He said, we've got to play the game. He said, we've got to clean up the penalties. We've got to be more aggressive offensively. We've got to execute better. And he said, defensively, we were playing catch all half. That has to stop.
Sounds about right.
Yeah, it does. Yeah, well, at least coach was watching the same game we were watching up here, because
They have been catching Oklahoma State's offense all day, and I think they got to get them in position. Oklahoma State's offense is attacking them. I think Indiana's defense is going to have to get back on the attack.
Zac Robinson in the first half, 15 of 20 passing for 192 yards and two touchdowns. He's also run it for 67 yards and two scores. This time they give it off to Hunter, the freshman. And Hunter fights his way up to the 18 and a half yard line.
Let's go, Cowboys!
Yeah, the difficulty, Sterling, in coming after them obviously lies in the fact that down 35-10, so you got to get after them.
Right.
But from a skill position standpoint,
I know
their guys are probably better than my guys.
I know what you're thinking, but I mean, down it's bad now. It's 25 down now.
Right.
And you got to do something to create a turnover, field position, something to jumpstart this football team.
Savage in a one-back set will take the toss with blockers. Bring it back across the defense, and he does. He gets it to the outside. What a run by Savage.
And that was a dumb block.
Boy, Savage did so much on his own, but it's coming back.
Now, was that Zac Robinson that made that block?
I think it was.
So he gets to throw to himself this play. Right? Make a penalty, you get the ball.
He'll just keep it on the option.
Now, watch the quick feet here. It's toss sweep out of tight bunch. Tracy Porter has contained the cutback. Look at the feet. Lateral quickness. Now, you can't make this block in the back, Zac Robinson. Obvious call by the ref. Negates a big play. What's interesting to me, kickoff return was a big play.
Right.
First play from scrimmage, a big play.
The block, yep. In the back on the offense, number 11. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Second down.
But Oklahoma State, which was mistake-free in the first half, comes out with two penalties immediately.
Remember, they ended the half with an interception.
Right.
So.
Yep.
Maybe that's when Indiana needs to get back in this game.
Mike Gundy, the head coach at Oklahoma State. He was the quarterback in that Holiday Bowl in 1988. He was 20 of 24 for a mere 315 yards. And Barry Sanders had 222 yards rushing.
I was just about to say, who was playing tailback that day?
Yeah, anytime you play action pass with that guy in the back, it's believable.
Second and 14. For the Cowboys, Hunter in the backfield. They'll take the handoff from Robinson, dragged down from behind. And a nice play made by Joe Kramer, fifth-year senior from Urbana, Ohio, general studies major.
Now we got to see, now all of a sudden Indiana's sub package comes on the game. And we haven't seen much of that, and I believe this is what they do well. There's the read, the give. Nice job by Kramer from the backside, closing down. He's been a nice surprise for them this year, but okay, now.
Get a three and out.
You put number 92, Middleton, on the nose. Look at Middleton, their best pass rusher is on the nose. They're gonna try and use him because of his quickness advantage on the inside.
Bowman in the slot left. Bowman can't make the catch. Phillips on the coverage, maybe a hair behind him.
There's a flash. I mean, the defensive back flashed in front of him and broke his concentration just enough. But Indiana's defense is off the field on third down, which is what they needed to do.
First punt of the ball game.
I mean, he got a flash right there.
Chris
that
Phillips.
Flash, yep. It was a little bit behind him,
yep.
Too. But that flash threw it off, threw that throw off a little bit. Now Indiana gets an opportunity.
Look at that. Another. Here we go now. This is kind of interesting. You have a tendency as an athlete with a big lead
to
mentally relax.
Sure.
Third penalty on the first series here in the second half for Oklahoma State.
Wow.
I guarantee you Mike Gundy's not happy about this. This is what a head coach hates.
Well, the only thing that could help Indiana right now is if they blocked it.
First punt tonight for Oklahoma State.
Or returned it.
That's five on the punt.
And this or shank it.
Or shank it. Into the bench of Oklahoma State.
Shank works too.
Wow, look at this.
Jeez. Spotted at the 26-yard line of Oklahoma State.
Hoosiers first and 10.
Mistakes for the Cowboys starting the third. Welcome back to Tempe, Arizona, the Insight Bowl, Mill Street, where tonight they'll barricade the road and the second largest New Year's Eve celebration in the country will take place right there.
I know, because I'll be there.
Outside of Times Square in New York City.
be right next to you.
I'll be at Times Square, too.
Well, look at this. Indiana starting at the Oklahoma State 26, their best starting point of the ball game. Thigpen finds a crease. Thigpen inside the 15 and run out of bounds by Quentin Moore.
Zone read. All of a sudden, they're starting to look like that Big Ten team we saw on tape.
Wow.
All the linemen pulling to the left. That's the read piece of it. Good job by 61 Wheeze. You see the seam open up and the explosion by Thigpen. An immediate first down.
This all set up after the 19-yard punt and the three penalties against Oklahoma State. First and 10. Lewis for Thigpen. Fighting his way inside the 10 to the 9-yard line.
Tackled by Peterson.
We're going to see Lewis pull that ball out of Thigpen's belly one of these times real soon. Because once you can establish that inside run, now you've got a chance to pull it back out and go.
I think, you got to stick with what got you here. And I think now, you know, it seems like you found a soft spot in the defense. You're able to pick up positive yardage. Leave it in the middle.
Where's Hardy? Fade route, no safety over top.
Instead, they throw it to the back, Payton, and he's not able to hold on.
Did a real good job that Oklahoma State defense did. Bumped Hardy, carried him inside. It's almost like what we call three cloud.
Right.
Corner hard, right in front of him, forcing him to go inside. I'll tell you what, Oklahoma State's defense, and I know our fans have got to be asking, how in the world is this football team 6-6? Because this defense has played really good tonight.
Now they're spreading them wide, empty set.
Hardy to the top of your screen, split left. Lewis for Hardy on the slip screen, and it's read perfectly by Donovan Woods.
No, not for a 6'7 guy. I don't think the slip screen for a 6'7 guy, Mike. I could be wrong.
Well, they're pressing him, okay? And Donovan Woods is a linebacker. Donovan Woods from behind. They pushed him on the inside. Jacob Lacy pressed him.
Right.
Forced him back inside, which is part of the slip screen anyway.
Yep.
But now you got everybody flying to the football.
Don't you need more field, too, to run that? You're compressed. You're so deep in their territory.
Fake field goal here. Fake field goal.
Austin Starr.
Fake field goal.
The usual holder is
fake field goal.
You called. Yep. Lewis takes it on a fourth down. Gives it to Starr. The kicker to the five. What a move by Starr, but he stopped at the one.
Oh, man. Could he get a first down?
He got the first down.
He got
down.
The first down.
He might.
He had to get inside the two, and Austin Starr. How about the little move at the 10?
Did you see him come back inside?
6 foot two, 203 pounds. I thought he was going to get tackled around the 10-yard line.
Look at this move. Oh,
and an eight. And now turn and go.
He needs to learn to run behind his pads a little bit more, though. I mean, how many times are you going to say that about a kicker? Watch this. Get behind your pads, son.
First and goal at the one for Indiana. Payton. Not going to get there. He was hit by Marquis Fountain.
Tackled by Sexton.
At the 2-yard line.
Offensive line wise, now Indiana's offensive line's got to make a statement right here. I mean, they have got to make a statement and they've got to move. Wow.
Look at all
there's
that arm.
There's three Oklahoma State Cowboys standing in the backfield waiting on the running back. They need to make a statement right here.
Second and goal inside the one. Payton, the tailback. And Lewis just dives forward.
Lewis offside defense.
As a flag comes in, and it's a touchdown for Lewis.
I'm putting it out there. Offside defense. Indiana needs a break. Great fake field goal, though.
Penalty marker now.
If they get a chance, if they come back in this game, he's the key. That run
that
right
run
there.
Was, yes. Oh, by far.
There is no way any kicker in the country should have made a first down given where he caught that
offside
football.
Offside defense. Penalty's decline.
So the touchdown stand for Kellen Lewis.
I don't know
who was offside.
I think they anticipated that, that
somebody
the
wanted to jump.
That jumped.
He wanted to.
And Austin Starr, an academic All-American in biology, got his football stripes with that run after the catch to get the first down. He converts the extra point. And a little life from the Hoosiers early in the third. Oklahoma State still in front, 35-17. After a 19-yard punt, Indiana goes 7 plays, 26 yards. Kellen Lewis on a 1-yard touchdown run, but Austin was the star on a fake field goal.
I really think they were trying to get it to the fullback, but Sterling,
yeah,
you describe it.
I mean, right here, the only thing I could tell him is learn to run behind your pads, but look at the spin move to get the first down. He took on the Cowboys and he won.
And how much respect does he get in the locker room?
Well, he got a whole lot from me because he knew how important it was for his football team to get 7 and not 3, and he got him the first down.
Good kickoff by Starr. Comes down at the goal line. Parrish Cox with it. Hit and drop at the 20-yard line. Quinton Moore. Let's set it down to Kim Jones.
Thank you, Bob. More of a bounce on this Indiana sideline than we've seen all game. I just got top secret news from the coaching staff. That fourth down conversion was a play put in especially for this football game. Austin Starr just ran by me. He's trying to get the crowd psyched up, and he's succeeding.
Certainly has. It's given him a lift, and the defense got a 3-and-out.
Yep.
A couple penalties obviously helped the cause.
If they can get another 3-and-out, all of a sudden, you've got a huge momentum shift and maybe a football game.
You got one-on-one on these three skill guys at the top. Everybody's matched up one-on-one at the top.
Savage, the tailback, is going to take the handoff. Works his way off the left side, and Joe Kramer makes the tackle after a gain of 1.
And you know, we haven't talked about today the fact that Oklahoma State stands at the line of scrimmage. They let you, they line up, then you line up, and then they call the play. And I think it helps you attack a defense because if you got smart enough football players to stand there, everybody obviously has to know what the system is. You get an opportunity to stay one step ahead of the defense, which is what has happened, especially in the first half of this game.
That's what they're doing right now. You look over at Mike Gundy. Tight bunch.
Second down, Robinson. Bryant, there's the yards after contact. He takes it across the 30 to the 33-yard line.
Stay on schedule. It's a phrase that you hear a lot of guys use. But right now, he's got, okay, he's got the catch. I think he's got to get 4 more yards. He gets the first down. Keep your offense on schedule. You go first down, second, just skipped another down right there. And that's what Indiana is, what's killing this defense, is they're just allowing Oklahoma State to continue to skip it down and just can't get them off the field.
Got a first and 10. Robinson. Bowman. What a catch down the sideline. Can't keep his balance in, but all fingertips for Darius Bowman.
And Leslie Mays just had pretty good coverage there, and he hesitated when the ball was in the air.
He couldn't get to him, Mike, to put his body on him. He could not get his body to him and able to just run him out of bounds.
Here comes the wheel route. He's on his underneath hip. He's in good. See the hesitation I was talking about right there?
Wow. Beautiful.
He had coverage.
Yeah, he did. He really did. I mean,
he
it's a
hesitated.
Great. I mean, you can't fault the throw either. I mean, my goodness. That was a beautiful throw by Zac Robinson.
39 yards. Robinson again feels some pressure. Robinson for Bowman. And it's nearly intercepted
twice
by Majors. And then Thomas.
Majors almost had it exactly right, Bob. In the air, and Thomas came flying out of nowhere. And that's what this team needs. Indiana needs to make a play here defensively because you just can't keep giving up 7 every time you're on the field. Nice elevation. Ball's in the air. It's still in the air. Austin Thomas.
Robinson has been picked off once. That came near the end of the first half by Nick Polk. Second and 10 for the Cowboys. Robinson to Savage. Savage has the edge inside the 25-yard line. Knocked down at the 23. Porter on the tackle.
The one knock against Tracy Porter as a potential first-round pick in the NFL draft is he's not consistently physical, okay? He's going to be on the edge. It's option. This is physical football. You got pitched.
beats the block and sticks his headgear in there. And Sterling doesn't do that often enough, but when he does, he's real.
But he knows that, because he said that's the one thing I came into this season wanting to be, and that is more physical, especially in the run game.
Now, he was hurt back in the first half with a neck injury. Came back to the ball game in the second quarter. Third and four for Robinson. Robinson keeps it. Good tackle, hiding for the 20, and he is short. Carrington came in and got a hit.
Now, Carrington's another one of those former high school running backs. They love his size and his speed. He's starting because Geno Johnson, the incumbent starter of the whole season, has been hurt. This is a guy that next year, along with Matt Mayberry, will form the basis of a real good linebacker unit. Fourth and two, it looks like they're going for it, Bob.
Certainly are, with the ball spotted just inside the 21-yard line of Indiana.
Slant.
Yeah, they've been working Dez Bryant on Tracy Porter all night on third down.
Slant.
Savage to the right of Robinson. Robinson back over the middle. What a catch by the tight end, Brandon Pettigrew, for a first down.
He's a man.
He's impressive. He is definitely impressive. I mean, watch him go post up in the middle, spins. I mean, look at the location of the football. I mean, the route was good. The location of the football was better. Zac Robinson doing just about everything right.
Great throw. Five for five in the red zone for Oklahoma State.
He threw it away from the outside leverage.
Yes, he did.
Moment in motion. Savage on the handoff. A spin off the edge. Fights his way inside the 10. Just spun away from Will Patterson and got an additional 5 yards.
You know, we're talking about 87, Brandon Pettigrew, okay?
Okay.
On this play, he's got to control the defensive end, and then he's going to work his way out and get the linebacker. Watch him. Chip, now go get the linebacker, ride him out. You can't do it any better than
that. No, you can't. I mean, you really can't. And this IU defense is starting to get worn down a little bit.
On a second down, this time.
They're starting to get worn down. I mean, you start to look at the guys in the middle, and they are just leaning on the offensive line of Oklahoma State. So I think we're going to start to see a lot more one-on-one coverage from Indiana, which means you're going to have to pack the box and try and stop the run. So the corners from Indiana are going to end up being one-on-one on the wide receivers of Oklahoma State, because somehow, some way, Indiana has got to get pressure on the backfield of Oklahoma State.
That time, Curlew and McClute made the nice play. Now it is third and seven.
One-on-one.
Savage in the backfield with Robinson. Bryant to the top of your screen. Robinson going to heave it right for Bryant, who goes up and gets it for the touchdown. Dez Bryant, second touchdown catch of the ball game.
One-on-one. I mean, you have to. I mean, they tried to do it. They did everything right. They didn't play bump. They tried to play off. They tried to disguise it. They did everything they possibly could. But, man, when you got that kind of skill on the outside, beautiful location of the football game. Look where it is.
Yeah, but, and I give them all that credit, but as a corner, Leslie Majors was 6 yards deep in the end zone before he even looked for the football.
And that's where he would normally play, Mike. They're not used to playing bump and run. I mean, they're not used to lining up in that compete mode, playing bump and run at the line of scrimmage.
Dan Bailey hits the extra point. Dez Bryant, a freshman, 6'2", 210 pounds. We've seen his strength. He went up and snatched that one. Oklahoma State in front, 42-17 here at the Insight Bowl. Oklahoma State answers Indiana's touchdown with a 10-play, 80-yard drive. Freshman Dez Bryant with a second touchdown catch of the ball game. Kick by Bailey, comes to the near sideline. And Indiana, turned by Brandon Walker Roby, out across the 30-yard line. Well, Christmas time in Tempe as we roll out 2007 here at the Insight Bowl. Oklahoma State in front. Hope you're enjoying it on NFL Network. 48,892 at the 19th annual Insight Bowl at Sun Devil Stadium in Tempe, Arizona. First and 10 for Indiana on the short end of a 42-17 score. Fisher on the reception on a first and 10 for the Hoosiers. He gets a couple, and that's it.
NFL Total Access has the latest news and information from around the league featuring exclusive team cam access. NFL Total Access Monday through Saturday at 7 Eastern only on NFL Network. What's the big news today? The Baltimore Ravens firing head coach Brian Billick.
After extending him a year ago, correct?
He had gotten a contract extension. I guess that 9-game losing streak during the year.
Yeah.
That'll catch you every time.
Yes, it will.
Second and 8. Thigpen finds a crease. Thigpen takes on the safety. Ricky Price at the 40-yard line, and he's brought down there.
When do you go hurry up, Mike? When would you start to play a little faster, a little more at the line?
Now? About a week ago.
Okay, yeah. I mean, there's a lot. I mean, a lot of just move in, make a call.
8-6, 32.
I don't think they're built that way.
They're not. No. They're not.
Hardy split to the bottom of the screen on a 3rd-and-2 for Indiana. Lewis looking for Hardy, knocked away nicely by Jacob Lacy.
Bad location of the throw. I mean, it's one of those where you're just trying to pick up the first down and you throw it to the defender's side of your wide receiver, which allows the defender to have a better chance of making a play on it than your wide receiver.
Michael Hines in to punt. Parrish Cox back deep for Oklahoma State. Cox, one of three players this year to return a punt and a kickoff for a touchdown. Calls for a fair catch at his own 28-yard line. So Oklahoma State's offense back out onto the field. They're in front 42-17 here at the Insight Bowl in the third.
Single one of
second and 3. Savage has the first down. Kirlew drags him down from behind.
Their wide receivers just block people. Dez Bryant that time, Chris Phillips. I'm so impressed with the physicality of the Oklahoma State skill position players.
Attack. They attack constantly.
Savage working the right side, thrown down at the 47-yard line.
I mean, it is kind of interesting to watch Oklahoma State with the lead, a big lead. I mean, we're at the line and we're going. And then you watch Indiana when they got the ball, and you're almost asleep because they're so slow in the huddle. And look, Oklahoma State's like, hey, let's see how many plays we can run out of. Playing faster, a lot of bounce in their step. Of course, they're up. But, I mean, that's what we expected to see from Indiana being down, especially after Oklahoma State just went down to score.
Second and 7 for the Cowboys. Savage resets in the backfield. Takes the handoff. Across midfield, tripped up at the 48-yard line. Ryan Fares on the tackle. Fares, a fifth-year senior from Indianapolis. Recreational sports management major. Started as a backup tight end with the Hoosiers.
There have been a lot of position changes in the last couple of years as these coaches try to get a handle on getting the best people on the field at the same time.
3rd-and-2 for Oklahoma State. Robinson intended for Bryant.
Different page there.
Which is interesting because we're all looking over getting the same, we're getting the same call from the sideline after we get at the line of scrimmage.
I think there was a difference in the leverage on the corner
to what to do.
That the wide receiver read versus what the
quarterback read. Yeah.
So am I going to run the hitch or slant, or am I going to run it out?
Right.
And I think the quarterback, Robinson, anticipated the out against an inside leverage quarter.
There you go.
Matt Fodge, whose last punt was 19 yards, sets this one. Much better punt. Flag on the play. Comes down at the 15-yard line. Tracy Porter. 34-yard punt. We'll check the flag.
And that's a 4th-and-3 situation. So if Indiana jumped.
Offside, number 23 on the defense.
Yep.
5-yard penalty results in a first down.
Adrian Burks jumped. 4th-and-3, first down.
Well, many interesting stories during bowl week, and Kim Jones has one of them.
Thank you, Bob. I am joined now by cornerback Martell Van Zandt, who should be starting in this game if not for the dislocated tendon in his ankle. Are you disappointed not to be in there?
Yeah, I really am. It's been really frustrating, you know, because I had turf toe, and then, you know, I'll be fine. Things will be all right. So don't worry about this.
Martell and I are joined by Allie Lee, the sign language interpreter for Martell. And Martell, I'm wondering if you can feel the atmosphere here tonight.
Yeah, I can. I can feel what's going on, and it's really loud, like the fireworks, but, you know, I want to be in there playing so much. You know, it's really frustrating. It's all right.
Back to you, Bob.
Well, he's got to enjoy what he's seen as the pass by Robinson goes to Pettigrew incomplete.
See that stem by the tight end on that one, Sterling?
I can't talk about him anymore, Mike, because I don't want people to think I'm in love with the guy. Okay, he's got great ability, but he seems to do everything right. And I guess because we don't get an opportunity to see a lot of tight ends because everybody's going to the quote-unquote spread, so it's hard to find a pure tight end. Converted basketball player, converted announcer, however you look at it, that's what they are. But, I mean, to see a guy play the position, I stand up wide receiver right now in the slot, he's impressive.
Second and 10 for Robinson. Savage off the right side, fights ahead, and he's near the first down marker.
And
he's got the first down. Back to Kim.
Martell, your roommate is Brandon Pettigrew. How much do you like what you're seeing from him tonight?
Yeah, I really like what he's doing out there on the field. He's really energetic during the game, so I'm excited for him, because that's my boy.
Now, he tells me you two have an awful lot of fun. He also says you inspire him. Do you know that you have that effect on your teammates?
Yeah, I think they see what I do and what I'm going through, you know, because of my deafness. You know, just the closeness of the team is really good.
Yeah, I hear this team gets along so well. What do you say we go back upstairs?
All right, back to you, Bob.
Thanks, Martell, a senior from Tyler, Texas. 29 tackles this season. On first and 10, Robinson finds his way to the 30-yard line as he was under pressure from Greg Brown, defensive tackle from Indiana.
You go ahead. Go ahead.
I know
wow.
We're talking about
tight ends. Sterling and Mike speechless.
Yeah, you know he does that to you.
The last three or four plays, Sterling and I have been watching Brandon Pettigrew, and we look at each other because two plays ago, he took the defensive end and just walked him to the sideline on
yep,
a run play.
He did.
And we just keep shaking our heads.
Second and 7. Savage comes set in the backfield with Robinson. Draw play, Savage. He's got plenty of room. He's got a first down. Takes it to the outside, and Bryant comes in as he's dragged out at the 4-yard line.
Wow.
Well, this one coming back. He dropped the flag at the 21.
Wow. Pettigrew going to do it for us one more time. Just extend the arms, move the feet.
Lock him out and push him.
Seth Newton is going to get called for Seth Newton, number 15.
He taped Superman on his back.
I mean, really didn't have to. We're going to call him that anyway.
I hope somebody else did it without him knowing it. Because, I mean, for me, for a junior in college to be doing that already, that's a little much. Don't you think?
No.
Okay. We have been told that one of his teammates actually put it on his
back. Okay, that's what I was hoping. It's like the kick me thing, except it said Pettigrew.
Oh, yeah.
Superman.
Yeah.
Well, Newton's penalty brings back a gorgeous run by Savage. So it's 2nd and 8. The waning seconds of the third. Hunter in a tailback. He'll take the handoff. Bounces it to the outside. The freshman can't get outside. Nice play that time by Nick Polk, the safety.
Well, I'm looking at Indiana's defense, and I guess I'm expecting to see 10 guys at the line of scrimmage and everybody trying to get to the backfield. I don't see that. I see, you know what, this is the defense we practiced there all, you know, for a month. And this is what they're doing. I mean, there's no sense of urgency. There's no, I guess I'm kind of shocked that I would expect to see a little more, I guess, sense of urgency is what I'm talking about.
Well, they're on the short end of a 42-17 score.
Big-time sense of urgency.
That's the end of 3 here in Tempe, Arizona, at the Inside Bowl. Oklahoma State dominating the Indiana Hoosiers.
Hope you're enjoying it here on NFL Network. Path to the draft is on NFL Network. Don't miss the 2008 Under Armour Senior Bowl. Top college seniors play for NFL coaches in this all-star matchup Saturday, January the 26th, only on NFL Network.
Now, I've watched an awful lot of tape of the top seniors in the country. Here's my top five, Sterling, and I think Bill Parcells is going to have to make a decision at the top end of the draft. Do I need a quarterback? Remember, the Dolphins took John Beck in the second round last year, but they got Matt Ryan from Boston College staring him in the face. What do you think?
Can't take him.
Why not?
Can't take him.
Why not?
Bill likes veteran guys.
Too many needs.
So, yeah, he likes veteran
guys.
Well,
they're two beasts at defensive tackle.
I like Dorsey.
Bowman.
I like Glenn Dorsey.
On a third and nine, has the first down. Lost the dribble. And I think Nick Polk recovered it.
I'm liking Nick Polk.
And that was a deliberate strip also. And Nick Polk is an athletic kid.
And that's what I mean, you know, when we just talked about the sense of urgency,
yep.
You know, going after the football, doing things like that, that's what you kind of wanted to see earlier.
Bowman had the first down.
There's the strip right there. 28, Leslie Majors, the corner. Third guy in, excellent job. That's what you do in this kind of game. You got to strip it. Now Polk with the hustle play.
Now, sense of urgency on offense.
Got to see it. Got to up-tempo this thing.
And if my horse is James Hardy, getting ready to ride him like Seattle Slough.
He's down here by himself. And here it goes.
Lewis. Pressure gets sacked. Marquise Fountain gets his third sack of the season.
And Sterling, you know what they were trying to do off that play action.
Come
play
straight.
Action doesn't work at 42-17.
No.
But they were trying to get Hardy down the sideline. But watch what happens right up the middle, Marquise Fountain.
But I think, you know what, and we're talking play action with a guy that's 6'7". I think you run the play action to give him time to get deep. I don't think you can just straight drop back and throw the football deep to him, because I'm not sure how fast, straight out,
right.
You know,
I
you talked about
that.
It earlier, straight out foot speed he has.
Loss of 10 on the play. Time to give it off on the inside to Peyton. Peyton takes it across the 25, the 27-yard line. Quentin Moore.
I thought that James Hardy's best game this year that I saw on tape was against Penn State. And they couldn't block Penn State's front. But what happened was Hardy ran a lot of short and intermediate routes, which I didn't think he could do.
Right.
And he did a nice job using his body, keeping the Penn State defenders off him, ran some digs, ran some curls. You don't see them do much of that.
No,
And that's what I'd like to see with him.
I agree.
Third and 10 for Indiana. Pressure on Lewis. Runs away from some of it, and he can't find Hardy. Donovan Woods brought the initial pressure.
That's exactly right, and it was on a twist stunt. He came from the outside linebacker, came inside, beat the tackle, and put the pressure on, flushed him out of the pocket.
So they are not able to capitalize on the fumble, and Indiana has to punt the ball away. Michael Hines will boot the football. Dez Bryant back deep. Bryant with a couple of touchdown catches in this game. Comes to the near sideline and into the Indiana bench. They'll spot it out at the 44-yard line. Tempe get here in the fourth quarter. Bill Lynch and Indiana trailing Oklahoma State 42-17. On December the 12th, Coach Gundy, Coach Lynch, and representatives from the Insight Bowl presided over the opening bell at the NASDAQ Market Site in New York City's Times Square to celebrate the 2007 Insight Bowl. So far, it's gone quite well for Coach Gundy and his Cowboys of Oklahoma State.
Say their stock is on the rise
as we count down the big man. First and 10, Savage. Gets hit by Kramer after a half-yard pickup. Fair is also there.
Well, I'm looking at a football team in Indiana that, you know what, They fulfilled the commitment that they made playing 13. They played the 12 regular season games, and it's almost like, and I know it's easy to say right now, that they were happy to get here. They accomplished that mission of playing the 13th game of their season.
You know what? I'm not sure. I don't think I agree with that, Sterling.
Okay.
I think they're outclassed physically. And I know you'd like to see a little more intensity and a little more, but they weren't built that way.
Right.
And what I think and hope, and I did their last bowl game. Maybe I'm the bad.
That might be, yeah, it might be you.
I did their bowl game 14 years ago, and their program went the wrong way at that point.
Right.
And they're at a seminal point in their program now, and they've got to continue to build. And the goal's got to be Rose Bowl, not.
But it's like Bill Lynch said, that you know, playing 13 was not the end.
Exactly.
But the beginning. But I'm saying that when you watch this football team, they don't have anybody that's trying to keep this team, you know, or trying to get this team going or jump started. We haven't seen that enthusiasm that we thought we would see, that, you know, they're extremely happy to be here. And I'm just saying, you know, looking at the way they are methodically going about things.
Well, they're getting their butts whipped by a more physical, I'm not even going to say more physical, but by a more talented football.
I agree. Oh, I concur.
Seth Newton with the catch, and he's got enough yardage for the first down on the 3rd and 9. But also, one of the reasons why they don't look enthusiastic is because of the play of Oklahoma State.
Oh, definitely. I'm not trying to minimize Oklahoma State at all. I'm just saying that based on the fact of the emotion of the season and the emotion of the play 13, which is play your 13th game, which is a bowl game, I was expecting to see a little more enthusiasm. I'm not disappointed at all. I just know that this football team has to, I think, understands where they're going.
And I think it's, you and I talked about it before the game, and you said to me, do you think they can hang in there?
Right.
And because we both knew from watching tape that Oklahoma State had more horses.
Yes, they did.
And that old saying, it's not about the X's and the O's, it's about the Jimmies and the Joes.
Yeah,
and the Jimmies and the Joes are on the Cowboy side today.
Yeah, that's true. That is true.
Will Patterson made a nice tackle there on the pass.
You trying to keep us on point here, Bob?
Play a game.
Play a game.
On the offense, 5-yard penalty, 2nd down.
Wow. 72 offensive snaps for Mike Gundy's squad. 45. Wow. In Indiana territory.
Yeah, that's going to win most of your ball games if you can do that. You play on the other team's side of the 50, yeah, that'll win you a lot of football games and not a lot of field goals.
And remember, a lot of that was set up by the defense, too. Constantly keeping Indiana in bad field position, getting 3 and outs, and constantly starting at their own 41-yard line.
That's very true.
But, Sterling, I think the one thing we did agree on about this whole thing with Indiana is it's got to be a building point.
Yeah.
And I think Coach Lynch knows that.
Yes, he does. He talked to us about that. Not the end, it's the beginning.
Savage pounds his way up to the 49-yard line. Carrington there to make the tackle, along with Mayberry.
And if it wasn't New Year's Eve, that'd be me right there. Head on, you know, I'd be ready to go to sleep when this is over. New Year's Eve, Bob. Bob's getting on a plane, so I'm going to have to celebrate for him.
I'll be thinking of you.
I'll be thinking of you too. You know, bored on a plane, bringing in the new year, 35,000 feet.
Sterling and I sitting out here, block from here, Mill Road or whatever they call that place.
Yeah, good luck with that. Good luck with that, Bob.
3rd and 15.
Double screen.
Nice play that time made by Porter as he read the screen to Savage.
And we've been talking a lot about Indiana. You look at Oklahoma State, and from an offensive skill position standpoint, they can compete with anybody, and they scored points on just about everybody on their schedule.
Yes, they did.
I think their offensive line's got to get a little better, and then the whole thing has got to be they got to begin to compete defensively, because that's where they lost 16.
Fodge with the punt. And bounds into the end zone for a touchback. 10:31 to go in the ball game. Oklahoma State dominating Indiana. 42-17 here at the Insight Bowl. Oklahoma State fans will be shining some belt buckles tonight.
I don't got that. Okay.
Shannon, come on. He's your wardrobe consultant.
I got a lot of outrageous clothes, Bob, but I don't got that look. I don't bring that to the NFL network. I don't got that.
You got that with a tie, though.
Okay, now I might have to think about that. Can I get the OU tie? Yeah, okay.
Big Ben, nowhere to go. Chinasa forced him back to the inside. a loss of a couple on the play. You know, one thing we need to talk about here, we talked about the offense of Oklahoma State, but how about the job that defensive coordinator Tim Beckman has done against a team that averages almost 32 points a game in the Indiana Hoosiers offensive?
And I think that's a great point, Bob. And he's in his first year coming over from Ohio State. He knows this staff at Indiana very well because not only was he in the Big Ten, but he was in the MAC with the coordinators from Indiana. So they all know each other, and Beckman's done a great job.
Lewis under pressure. Lewis zips it and it's dropped at the 30-yard line. He tried to get it to his tight end, Nick Sexton.
That could have been a big day for Nick Sexton. That would have been the second catch.
Yep. Yeah, he could retire.
I mean, that's coming into the game.
That's a career.
He could have doubled his output.
You know, it's just one of those things that, you know what, the Indiana offense, they have to have taken something away from a game like this. And you know, your horse has got to step up. He had two catchable balls that I thought he should have made the catch.
Right.
Both of them were tough, but
both
I thought
in
he
the first half when it could have made a difference.
I thought he should have made those catches. But you know what, it's a situation where the quarterback would be another year of experience and be better. So I expect to see this football team in Indiana back in a bowl game again. I don't think this is the end for them.
Lewis under duress again on a 3rd and 13. Lewis has a first down across the 35 to the 38-yard line.
And he's gonna have that. That's portable. Yeah. Oh, that ability right there is portable. That works anywhere. Bowl game, practice.
And as you say all the time, and I've stolen it from you by the way, officially, and that is you either wake up in the morning with it or you don't.
Yeah, you can't coach this right here. This is not something you teach. You don't show film and be like, yeah, we can do this whenever we want. Yeah,
it's like basketball coaches say you can't coach height.
Yeah.
And with this guy, it's the same thing.
Oh, yeah.
So first to 10 for Indiana. Eight. Grabbed by Levine at the 45-yard line. Picks up about seven.
I'm kind of wondering if Josiah Sears is happy he got that mohawk in.
Yeah, I mean,
what do you think?
Probably not. I doubt it. Yeah. But you see what I'm saying about the offense and the sense of urgency? You know, 9 minutes left in this game. 42-17 is our score. And, you know, hey, let's go huddle up. Make sure we get all of us are on the same page. You know, I guess I would like to see a little more sense of urgency from this football team, which led me to say that, okay, maybe they are glad they got it. Maybe, you know, it is a stepping stone.
Second and three for Peyton. Peyton's got a first down and more. Wrestled down at the 41-yard line by Quentin Moore. But Ryan Peyton with a nice run. Redshirt sophomore from Fort Wayne, Indiana.
205-pound kid, good lead block, gets up in the hole. A little bigger than Thigpen.
Yeah, yeah. Made a great move there to spring himself, too.
Yep.
I mean, right at the line of scrimmage, great jump inside.
Jump cut.
Yeah.
First down for Indiana.
They come.
Peyton to Means. He's going to throw it. Means has his quarterback, Lewis. And Lewis gets dang tackled at the 25-yard line.
I guess Bill Lynch got a bunch of plays. He called them all, too.
There you go, Sterling.
He's not leaving any bullets in the gun either. I just wish they would shoot a little faster. That's all I want.
Here comes the give, the flip. Kellen Lewis had taken off. Good throw. You know, that's a well-designed play.
Yes, it was.
Would have liked it about when it was 10-3.
Got one-on-ones down here.
Here we go. Lewis is going to keep it. Lewis, a little hesitation, and dives to the 20-yard line.
See, that's my athlete's better than your athlete right there. That in-space thing that we talked about, right?
Right.
I mean, they, from a scheme perspective, Oklahoma State played that beautifully.
Yeah.
But my athlete was
better than your athlete. And, you know, we got second and 5.
Right.
I just like to see 1st and 10 a little faster. That's all.
You really don't like that huddle.
I mean, he's done a really adequate job, you know, running and throwing the football. But I just like to see them play a little faster.
2nd and 5 for the Hoosiers. Lewis zips a fastball through the hands of Hardy.
Wow. I'm shocked. I really am. I mean, when you're the bell cow, when you're the guy that everybody in the country's talking about, converted basketball player, I'm shocked. I mean, that's three balls that's gone through his hands.
And by the way, well thrown by Lewis away from the leverage corner.
Yes, sir.
That should have been a catch.
I mean, I'm shocked. I just think that, you know what, he's been out of the game for so long, you know what I'm saying, not having balls thrown to him, that his concentration has gone a little bit. Now all receivers go through it. When it happened to us, we all go through it.
Third and five for Lewis. Gonna lob one left for Means, and too far incomplete. There's a flag on the play as Ricky Price was on the back of Means.
That could be uncatchable, though.
But was it uncatchable because he was holding
him? No.
He rode him like a cowpoke.
He's a cowboy. What is he supposed to do? That had to be uncatchable. I mean, a receiver. And I
was just about to say, and I'm a defensive back, and I usually don't even say it.
On the defense, number six. 15-yard penalty, previous spot, automatic first down.
Okay. I mean, I'm looking right here, and
he's holding him. He's holding him. He's holding him. He's pushing him. That's why he couldn't get the football.
He run faster.
He couldn't. He was being held.
Okay. Good call by the officials, and you know what? They got a better view of it than I had. I had the wrong angle. And that's what happens when you're 6,000 feet, you know? You really can't see those ants.
Yeah, speaking of 6,000 feet, I tried to run up Cush's Hill, Cush Mountain yesterday.
That's foolish. Why'd you do that? You should call me on those things. And talk you out of it.
Consult with Sterling on that one.
Wow. Talk you out of it.
First and goal at the 5 for Indiana.
There's your name.
Sears with a touchdown. Josiah Sears gets his fourth touchdown, one of the co-captains for the Hoosiers.
That's his 50th touch of the season.
Okay.
Six touchdowns.
Pretty good percentage.
Not bad.
Yeah, that's
not
pretty
bad.
Good. Pretty good. Nice cut. Nice cut.
He's a strong kid now.
He really is.
Wonder if that was girlfriend or if it was hoping it would become girlfriend.
Hey, I'm just glad that somebody's showing some emotion.
Look at the number.
Spears jersey.
It's his number, right?
Yeah. But he got called for an unsportsmanlike.
That's a really good toss. Maybe he's a quarterback. Is that a 15-yard penalty?
And she caught it, too. That was kind of like the bridesmaid thing. You know, you throw the thing up in the air and the next one gets married. What's that tradition?
The bouquet?
There you go, the bouquet.
I can read. I don't like to read, but I can.
Sears with the touchdown. Star for the extra point. Snap is good.
Take a piece of that?
Yeah, look at it. You got a piece of it, but it got through. So Josiah Sears with the touchdown run as he scores in the inside bowl. Indiana gets a touchdown back on co-captain Josiah Spears' touchdown run. He told us what it means to be the captain.
It's a special thing because I grew up in Indiana. I've been an Indiana fan my whole life. You know, I'm an Indiana boy, and to be the captain of, you know, the school you've looked at and, you know, loved your whole life is, you know, is a special thing. It's a dream come true. And I can't really, you know, I've thanked my teammates and the opportunities I've had, but I could never thank them enough for that opportunity because, you know, just to be anytime you're voted a leader by your peers is special. But, you know, for me to be, you know, that at Indiana University is really cool.
Sears from Greenfield, Indiana, Greenfield Central High School, a finance major, fifth-year senior, gets a touchdown run.
Threw the ball in the stands.
And that's why they're kicking from the 15.
Okay. I just like somebody showing some emotion down there.
Knox from the 20. Slips and falls at the 32-yard line as flags come flying in.
Okay, I could
have quadrant.
That call. Bob, I had that call. I was all over it.
Now, we're assuming that's girlfriend, right? And she's been called about 30 times already because you're on television, right?
During the return, number 48, on the return team, block in the back. Senior penalty. First down.
Yeah, we're assuming that's the girlfriend. If it's not, She will be.
It might be.
Yeah.
he pointed at her.
You got the job if you want it.
Pretty good throw, too.
If he's throwing it to her.
Did she catch it? Or did somebody give it? But she caught it. Very nice.
Grab.
Because I saw the white shirt up there catching it, right?
Mailbox yeah. is full.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
So it'll be first and 10 for Oklahoma State at their own 21-yard line after the penalty with 6:56 to go here at the inside bowl. Oklahoma State dominant in the first half on their first five possessions. Five offensive touchdowns.
Tracy Porter faking like he might come on corner blitz at the top of the screen.
Hand off to Savage. Nowhere to go. McClurg was there. Middle linebacker, Joe Kramer, one of the defensive tackles to make the play.
Joe Kramer's played pretty well.
He has. He really has. He's done a good job of getting off the line of scrimmage and getting his hands into the Oklahoma State offensive lineman. He's done a good job of controlling the gap that he has been placed in. He really has had a good night.
He's a try-hard fifth-year senior that's a tough kid and has made plays. And the coaching staff said was one of the most pleasant surprises of the year.
Savage again on a second and 11. And once again, it's Kramer who makes the tackle.
Right on time. And now you got third down. Here comes the sub package. And, you know, they're going to try. But the interesting thing to me is we called Greg Middleton's name, I think, one time the whole game.
And that was when he lined up over the center.
He lined up offside, right?
Yeah, he did. Yeah,
lined up
offside. Did line up in the neutral zone, yeah.
And he's a guy with 16 sacks, which is more than any other football player in the country.
But, you know, I like to say, Mike, if you don't stop the run, you don't get the opportunity to rush the passer. And they haven't done a real good job stopping the run.
I agree with that 100%. He's on the nose right now.
Third and 7. Savage has it shut down as he fights the 30-yard line. Mayberry can't shoot again. The middle linebacker, you know, you think about it. Middleton, 16 sacks, most in the country. Hardy, 16 touchdown catches, second most in the entire country, and both guys have been silenced in this game.
Yeah, well, I think Hardy will be the more disappointed party because he has had opportunities to make plays. You know, you don't stop the run. We just talked about, you know, Greg, not Greg Middleton.
Sterling, I agree with you.
I mean, so I think Hardy will be the more disappointed Hoosier when this game is over.
Oklahoma State fans felt the punter was rough. No flag on the play. Indiana back on offense. They trail 42-24. On Indiana's last possession, Josiah Sears scored on a touchdown to make it 42-24 in favor of Oklahoma State. Then after he scored, pointed to the crowd and threw a perfect pass into the stands. A lucky young lady made the catch. Kim Jones, you have the lucky winner.
Investigative journalism, guys. You asked for it, you got it. This is Lindy Arnold, girlfriend of Josiah Spears. Nice catch, Lindy.
Thank you.
You didn't know he was going to do that.
I had no idea. Normally, he doesn't even look at me during the game.
You guys are clearly having a good time, even though Oklahoma State's dominating this game. What's the atmosphere been like here?
You know, we're just making the best of it. Everyone's enjoying themselves. We're all happy to be here. It's a great atmosphere.
Are you also an Indiana student?
Actually, we both just graduated in December.
Now, you did not know about the haircut, so I've got to ask, what do you think about the mohawk?
His mom and I were watching him as they came through the walk, and we both looked at each other like, uh-oh, but it's cool. I like it.
Did he get more bonus points, though, when he points you out and throws you the ball?
He got big-time bonus points right there. That's for sure.
And you're getting a ton of phone calls. Your phone's going off right now.
And right now, I'm probably at, like, 30 missed calls right here.
Lindy Arnold, you might have had one of the best catches by a Hoosier tonight.
I don't know about that. I'm happy with it, but.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. You just made our booth full of guys very happy.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you, Bob.
Good job, Kim.
Yeah, I think she probably did have the best catch of the night by Hoosier.
I mean, I don't know.
She might not be 6'7" like James Hardy, but she caught the ball better.
She
today.
Caught the ball very well, and the really good throw, though.
Yeah. He didn't even use the seam.
Big pass.
with some room. Big pen inside the 30 and dragged out at the 25-yard line by Quentin Moore. I don't know. I think Austin Starr had the best catch of the night.
No, he had the best run of the night.
He had to catch it
first.
Kicker,
too. He had to catch it.
It's a little flip.
Kicker.
Wow. Bob, you... Okay, all right.
Did you notice that Josiah Sears threw a perfect spiral to her and didn't use the laces, though?
I just like the way he pointed where he was throwing, and he was very accurate.
Very Joe Mary point.
Tom Brady like.
Or Steve Young, you know, he used to scramble and point. And then,
yeah, but that was the run.
That's true. See, the only thing about Starr was Starr had fear in his heart that he might get blown up at any point when he was trying to catch it.
No. You put that play in. You know that the kicker is going to get it done for you. I think he was looking forward to contact after that catch.
It's like the movie Stripes. Blown up, sir.
Second and 10 for Lewis. And that one's incomplete. Well, the path to the draft is on NFL Network. Don't miss exclusive coverage of the NFL Scouting Combine. Top NFL draft prospects show off their skills for NFL coaches and clubs. The NFL Scouting Combine. Log on to IWantNFLNetwork.com to find out how you can get it.
I want you guys to know I have two official bets already lined up for the Combine. One is with wide receiver Donnie Avery from the University of Houston.
Okay.
And the second one is with Tracy Porter. They both told me they're going to run sub-4 threes at the Combine.
Wow.
Sterling, that's a sucker bet.
That's a
sucker bet.
That will not happen.
No. Deion's the only one that did that.
Lewis needs the 15, and he's got the first down of the 14.
I'm going to tell you the great story by Deion.
Okay.
And this was told to me by Bill Belichick. When Deion went to the Combine years ago, everybody couldn't wait to see everybody was at the 40-yard dash finish with their clocks and their watches. He ran, urban legend says, 4-2 something.
Right.
He knew he did it. And he just waved at everybody and kept going right in the tunnel.
Yeah.
Went right to the airport, went home. Didn't even come back.
A little Flipper Anderson, huh?
He right just waved and kept going into the tunnel in Indianapolis Stadium and left.
Like only Deion can
Does
do.
That sound like Deion or what? Just okay, I know I did it.
And the legend continues.
It continues. I know I did it. See y'all.
You know, I was going to run 4.8 at the Combine, so I didn't run at the Combine. So I didn't run at the Combine.
False start on the offense, number 50.
John Sandberg, honorable mention, all Big Ten, fifth-year senior from North White High School in Indiana. Criminal justice major called for the penalty.
I didn't even get invited to the Combine. I ran my 4.7 at Boston College.
There you go. I mean, that 4.7 is portable. You can run that anywhere.
I had Kellen Lewis earlier
about 3 a.m. a few times.
First and 15, and zips it over the head of Hardy. So it'll be second and 15 for Indiana. They led 3-0. Opening possession of the ball game, had a nice drive going, had to settle for a field goal, and then Oklahoma State on the next 5 offensive possessions scored touchdowns.
Kind of fun for Mike Gundy because, of course, his offensive coordinator Larry Fedora left to become the head coach at Southern Miss.
Mm-hmm.
Which I think is a tough spot to walk into given the success of Jeff Bauer over the years. But nonetheless, how about you're the head coach, your offensive coordinator leaves, and you score 5 consecutive touchdowns out the gate.
Wow, is it this easy to call plays again?
Second and 15 for the Hoosiers. Payton to the left of Lewis in the backfield. Lewis under pressure from Fountain, and he has to throw it away. Marquise Fountain, the redshirt senior, has done a very nice job in this game.
He's kept contained, and we talked about the success early by Indiana was on the legs of Kellen Winslow, and I think for the most part, Marquise Fountain, Sexton, the front 7 of this Oklahoma State defense has done a great job. And I really think, obviously, we keep talking about the offensive scores by Oklahoma State,
right,
but I think it's the defensive players, including a first-time starter like Terrence Anderson.
Yeah, kid gets his first start of the year. He's done a very nice job. Third and 15 for Indiana.
Single coverage down the bottom there. Sterling, 82.
Hardy's that receiver over the middle. Too high for Hardy. Try to get him on a cross with Cox trailing.
And he was, you know, that was a bad throw. But it's been a struggle for the big man tonight. It's been a struggle for him to keep his confidence, struggle for him to get free and find some space. And the catches he's had had a chance to make, they've been tough. You know, all of us have been there. We've been there, done that. You know, when it doesn't go your way in a game like where you need to put up the numbers that everybody's accustomed to you putting up. So we've all been there.
37-yard field goal attempt for Austin Starr. And a fake low snap to get it down, and Starr with a nice kick to knock it through and get three for Indiana. So Austin Starr, who had a big catch and run to set up a first and goal. It's a 37-yard field goal. Oklahoma State in front here in the fourth. Welcome back to Sun Devil Stadium here in the fourth quarter. Oklahoma State in a dominant performance against Indiana. They lead it 42-27. Chilly temperatures here as night falls in Tempe.
Beautiful day.
Bob Papa, Mike Mayock, Sterling Sharp, and Kim Jones. So glad you can join us. Onside kick time. It is a two-possession game.
So they were waiting for the three-minute mark to play a little faster? Is that it?
3:08 to go.
Gotcha.
Starr. And a recovery for Oklahoma State. Good job by the Cowboys. And that's
Pettigrew.
Pettigrew, the tight end. He's done everything.
Oh, he's on the hands team, too? Who knew?
Go figure. Hey, after that catch you made out of bounds, right?
Go figure. Yeah, who knew?
This is the kind of kick where you're really trying to drive it into the ground and get it to go higher than it did here. If it goes higher, you got a chance. There, catch it, roll, ball game.
You notice nobody wanted to hit the big 6'6 guy. No one wanted to tag.
So first and 10 for Oklahoma State at the 39-yard line of Indiana. Dominant performance by the Cowboys. Savage tucks it into the line. Curlew got a hit on him, along with Greg Brown. Brown's been active in this ball game. Gain of 5 on the play.
So Mike, you talked about what Oklahoma State's defense is going to have to do for this offense to help take them to new heights. What about Indiana's defense? What are they going to have to do?
I think the reason they're so vanilla on first and second downs is because a year ago they got beat up a little bit trying to zone blitz and play some games, and they didn't have the athletes to cover at the back end.
Gotcha.
So I think they're hoping to get a little bit better both up front, where they had one dominant player this year,
yep,
but also throughout the set to get more athletic in the back seven.
Okay.
And I think when they do that, they'll be more aggressive.
Second and 5, Savage gets the yard, and that's it. To the 33-yard line.
I mean, for instance, Matt Mayberry and Justin Carrington are two sophomore linebackers who were high school running backs. They feel like those two kids are real athletic, just very raw.
Right.
And I think they feel like they'll be better football players next year, and it's a young team. Austin Thomas is a sophomore. Nick Polk is a sophomore. So
I got you.
They're hoping that as they get more athletic, they can begin to be a little bit more aggressive defense.
Okay.
Yep.
Timeout, Indiana. We're 2:10 to go in the ballgame.
Curlow's a sophomore. Patterson. All three linebackers will be sophomore or juniors next year. I mean, so they're a young football team. I'm impressed. I love sitting down talking with their defensive coordinators, Joe Balsick and Brian George, both in their third year coming out of the MAC conference. And I think they get along. They like their young team. I think they're, you know, they're playing against a guy like Zac Robinson, is such a talented kid. It becomes difficult.
Yeah. Speaking of Zac Robinson, Mike, just a great performance tonight.
Yeah. And, you know, the zone read, he keeps it. Wide receivers do a great job blocking down the field. It's a touchdown. Throwing the football. Adarius Bowman, wide open, off play action. Quarterback sneak, Robinson. He throws the football. This time, Dez Bryant, one-on-one catch for his second touchdown reception. And you talk about youth, and they have some youth too. Still.
Yeah, oh yeah. And with all those guys, those young skilled guys coming back, getting more skill.
Double move. Third and 4, looking for Bryant, who brings it in at the 1. What a catch by Dez Bryant. He took it away from the defender.
Speaking of which.
Speaking of youth, that youth was served, but who did he take it away from?
That was a double move. Who did he get?
Looks like Tracy Porter on the outside.
Yep.
I mean,
yep.
There's the stutter. There's the go. Tracy's got outside leverage. You got to go get it. Who was the more aggressive guy on that?
Yeah, the receiver was.
Absolutely.
On that.
Used his body, went up and got
it. He just wanted it more.
Tracy's got to be more physical there because he certainly was in a position to make a play.
Yes, he was. Yes, he was.
So first and goal. Robinson lost the football, but it's recovered by Oklahoma State.
42 points on the board, and they're going double move. Huh?
They keep attacking. Hey, I got all the bullets. I got a lot of bullets. I'm going to use them all. That's what Coach Mike Gundy told us this week. So whatever plays he's got, he's calling.
Yep. Julius Croslin recovered the fumble. Now, you think because Indiana called the timeout, they said,
on the play, Oklahoma State is charged with a one-yard
rushing loss. Pettigrew doesn't have a touchdown. Pettigrew doesn't have a touchdown.
He's still in the game.
Yeah, he just looked back at the quarterback and said, hey, Zach, throw it to me.
Hey, I don't have a touchdown.
Second and goal. They give it to Croslin instead, and he gets about the four-yard line, and he's turned back.
And if I'm Indiana, which they're doing right now, they're flying around, and they're a little upset, I think.
Yeah.
You know? And that's their job. Go stop them.
Yeah.
Play football.
Hey, you got coaches. You had meetings. You had practice time. It's not Oklahoma State job to keep the score down.
Indiana calls a timeout.
And again, you know, kind of go back to the double move and the deep ball to Bryant. You know, Indiana called the timeout.
Yes, they did. Yes, they did.
So Oklahoma State said, hey, we were more than happy to run the clock out with Savage. You call the timeout.
Oh, you're still playing?
Here comes Dez Bryant.
Oh, wait, are you still playing? Oh, okay. So if you're still playing, then we'll keep running our offense.
Sort of like in the, if you remember, in the Cowboys-Patriots game earlier this year, everyone said the Patriots tried to run it up late, and they scored that late touchdown. Everyone forgets with a minute 38 to go, Wade Phillips called the timeout.
Yes.
And Dallas and New England said, okay, you're going to call a timeout. That means we're going to keep playing.
Exactly. I just think that when you get in a bowl game and you know, having been a senior in a bowl game, you know, you get an opportunity to play against a pretty good team because they're in a bowl game and you get a chance to compete. I mean, you got to play at a high level all the time. But, I mean, it's one of those situations where you're starting to be scrutinized in every facet of your life when you're a college senior with some talent. So you got to show up every single day.
Third and goal for Oklahoma State. Robinson, he's got a couple rushing touchdowns, takes on a couple defenders and gets planted at the two-yard line. Thomas came up from his safety spot.
And he did, and he did plant Zac.
Who called a timeout?
That would be
gain of three.
Timeout, Indiana.
That's their third. Well, that's my point. I mean, you're waiting on 3 minutes to start. All of a sudden, now you want to.
Let's face it. Coach Lynch and his squad are not going to win this football game. But let's talk about what they've been through this year with the passing of Coach Heppner back in June. And they did. This is going to be a successful season. They got 7 wins, and they got to the first bowl game since 1993. They got to that 13th game.
And there's excitement and energy at the University of Indiana for their football program for the first time in a long time. And the basis and the foundation of that was Coach Heppner. And I think because every coach on his staff had a connection to him, and because of the players, that's been carried forward. But Sterling, what you and I talked about with Coach Lynch is that's got to be the basis going forward.
Right.
The Rose Bowl has got to be the goal if you're a Big Ten team.
Because now you're one of the top 10 teams in the country. You're exactly right. And it's not, you know, we keep saying it. It's not the end of, you know, it's not the end of the dream of playing 13 games and getting to a bowl game. It's the beginning, because now you can build on it.
Croslin in for the touchdown. So the senior from Amarillo, Texas, gets his 7th rushing touchdown of the season. And Oklahoma State adds another score as Coach Mike Gundy get the bath, little bath, little Gatorade bath.
On the 1-point conversion attempt, Reynolds to hold.
A little ice water on a cold night here in Tempe.
Oh, man. They got him pretty good, too.
They got him real good.
Most points scored in the bowl game by Oklahoma State since they hung 62 on Wyoming back in 1988 when Mike Gundy was the quarterback for Oklahoma State.
Yep. Pretty good football player, too.
I like his energy and his enthusiasm as a coach. I mean, you know, having been around Pete Carroll, the USC head coach, kind of brings the same energy, enthusiasm, and looseness around his team. You know, they understand and have a good understanding of when they need to be businesslike. Had some kids at practice the other day, Oklahoma State did. Man, those guys were wonderful with the kids out there. So I like his enthusiasm, his energy, love his vision, love listening to him talk football. So know for sure that Oklahoma State is definitely headed in the right direction with him leading his program.
Fourth most points scored during this bowl season. Central Michigan scored 48 in their loss to Purdue.
Did that Oregon score 56? Is that Oregon scoring 56 without Dennis Dixon? Oregon without Dennis Dixon?
Jonathan Stewart must have gone off.
Because I've never seen the backup quarterback play, but when I saw Dennis Dixon throughout the year, I thought, wow.
You know who the backup is?
No.
Brady Lee's brother. I mean, Ryan Lee's brother, Brady.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Kickoff taken by one of the up men for Indiana. It's Deontay Mack, a freshman linebacker, takes it up to the 47-yard line.
By
41 seconds to go in the ball game. That's where Indiana will start. First and 10.
DeAndre was, he had purpose on that return. He looked good bringing that thing up the middle. This has got to be the longest return of the night for Indiana. 27 yards.
And it was a linebacker.
Everybody's auditioning for a job.
Kellen Lewis out of the shotgun set for Indiana. 41 seconds to go, out of timeout. Lewis over the middle. Means has it. Wrestled down at the Oklahoma State 44-yard line. Indiana cannot stop the clock with a timeout. Second and one. Hardy. First down, nice move by Hardy as he takes it to the 30. He'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go to reset the chains.
It's a pretty impressive move for a 6'7 guy, though.
You and I both looked at each other and said, wow.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, a little bit of short area quickness, explosion.
And that's been there. I think that's been there all night.
Is that been able to catch?
First and 10, Lewis. Looking to the end zone, and it is caught. Caught for a touchdown. James Bailey took it away from Terrence Anderson. And Bailey with a nifty catch, his second touchdown of the season.
Just wanted it more, Bob. That's all it is.
Yep.
He wanted it more. I mean, he's there. It's competition for the football. He went up at the highest point, made the catch. He wanted it more. That's all it was.
30 yards, ties his longest catch of the season. The junior from Detroit
took it away from Terrence Anderson, who had pretty good position.
Pretty good, really good position. Yep.
With 1 second to go. Indiana's going to go for two.
I just thought all this could have took place a little faster. Still say that. Leaving here without getting that point across.
Tate stops short. Cox and Seb Clements stopped him short on the two-point conversion.
Had they made that, it would have been the third consecutive year that the inside ball totaled 85 points.
They played a little faster early on. They could have gotten to that 85-point mark. I'm getting my point across, Bob.
Inside irony, I guess.
I am getting my point across that I thought Indiana could have played a lot faster, a lot earlier in the games, no huddle stuff.
And Indiana winds up with their season average, point total-wise, around 32 points per game, but really.
Juggernaut. They ran into a juggernaut. They ran into a really nice-looking juggernaut tonight.
The score is not indicative of the way Oklahoma State dominated this game.
No.
It's 35-10. At the half. And Steele comes in again.
Don't kick it to 87.
Do you notice who's deep on the hands team, guys? That's Zac Robinson.
Zac Robinson.
Quarterback.
Quarterback.
Deep guy on the hands team is Zac Robinson.
None at all.
That's just to make sure he gets the MVP of this game. That's all that is.
Does not get a kickoff return. Harris Cox goes down, takes the ding, and that's it. 2007 Inside Bowl goes to the Oklahoma State Cowboys as they dominate this football game and win it by a score of 49-33. Mike, your comments as far as the fireworks we saw from Oklahoma State's offense.
We talked about how good their skill position people were, and as advertised, they delivered. The physicality of the wide receivers, Sterling, totally impressed me.
And we talked about the defense and how they had to wear the hat in this football game. And Oklahoma State did a great job of, A, controlling the quarterback. You control the quarterback, you control a lot of IU's running game, and you definitely control Hardy, the wide receiver.
Mike Gundy, the winning coach, he's with Kim Jones.
Thank you, Bob. Joined by a damp Mike Gundy, you've got to be pleased with that performance, coach.
I was very proud of our team. They competed hard. We had a few penalties in the second half that I wasn't real happy with, but guys were just competing and trying to play really hard. And I have to give a lot of credit to Indiana and their coaching staff and their players for fighting back. And they got down, but they continued to fight and ended up kind of making a game of it late. So I was proud of their staff and their team.
And your team matched their energy level. You know, people at home are saying, man, that's not a 7-6 football team.
Well, our players understand that we don't ever make excuses, but we did play a fairly difficult schedule this year, and we understand that, but that's part of building a program. So we're looking forward to the future. A lot of credit goes to our seniors for the leadership they provided, and then the young players have to step up from this point on, and the coaching staff did a tremendous job.
Congratulations, coach.
Thank you. Appreciate NFL Network.
Well, Mike Gundy's squad comes away with the victory. The final score from the Inside Bowl, Oklahoma State 49, Indiana 33. Join the NFL Network for the best showcase of college talent when we bring you the Senior Bowl on January the 26th at 4 p.m. Coming up next on NFL Network, it's Total Access with Fran Charles, TD, and Steve Mariucci. For Mike Mayock, Sterling Sharp, and Kim Jones, I'm Bob Pompa saying good night from Tempe, Arizona. Oklahoma State, the winner in the Inside Bowl.